Valley Conference season takes its toll, but North Dakota State has answered the challenge, and with 2 weeks left, are once again top the standings. Today, the Bison honor their seniors, hosting Indiana State in the final regular season game at the Fargo Dome. It's coming up next on the KBOI Camp YR Bison Network.
Get your horns
Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the northeast corner of the Fargo Dome. Head coach Chris Kleiman and the North Dakota State football program would like to recognize 11 seniors making their final regular season home appearance in front of Bison Nation at Gate City Bank Field at the Fargo Dome this afternoon. These 11 student athletes have admirably represented North Dakota State University over their careers and have lived up to the expectations of being an NDSU student athlete and a member of the Bison football program. Their list of accomplishments is remarkable and reads as follows. A 52-4 overall record, including a 30-2 home mark over that time and a 27-3 mark in the Valley. Consists from ESPN College Game Day in 2013 and 2014 and Sports Center on the Road in 2015. A 3-0 mark against FBS competition with wins over Kansas State, Iowa State, and Iowa. A 12-0 NCAA playoff record, an FCS record 33-game winning streak, three consecutive Missouri Valley Conference championships, and a chance for a fourth this season. And back-to-back-to-back-to-back NCAA FCS national championships. Bison Nation, these young men have given blood, sweat, and tears to North Dakota State and Bison football. Join us as we recognize our 2016 Bison football seniors. Defensive end from DePere, Wisconsin, number 97, Brad Ambrosius. Running back from Greenwood, Missouri, number 22, King Frazier. Linebacker from Belleville, Illinois, number 47, Pierre G. Tucker. Offensive lineman from Apple Valley, Minnesota, number 66, Zach Johnson. Offensive lineman from Beach, North Dakota, number 78, Landon Leckler. Linebacker and now student assistant coach from Plattsmouth, Nebraska, Bo Lekas. Cornerback from Dallas, Texas, number 2, Quinton McCoy. Running back from Moorhead, Minnesota, number 25, Chase Morlock. Wide receiver from Kewaskum, Wisconsin, number 13, Eric Perkins. Offensive lineman from Leonard, North Dakota, number 70, Jack Plankers. Linebacker from Harvey, North Dakota, number 41, MJ Stumpf. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your 2016 North Dakota State Bison football seniors.
A special group, obviously, of North Dakota kids. A lot of these guys we saw playing many, many years ago when they were in high school, the Jack Plankers, the Landon Lecklers, the MJ Stumps. Unique that this senior class, as small as it is, featuring a lot of young kids that we had a chance to watch, including the young man from right across the river in Moorhead, Minnesota, Chase Morlock.
Yeah, you have to lump him into that group. You're right, but and these guys, too, come from, other than Chase, from small towns, too, in North Dakota that came to the program, some of them as walk-ons, and built their way into the starting lineup and impact players on this program.
And you look at it, this is the last of the smallest senior class the Bison have had since 2012 when they had seven. This group only has 11 kids, and it's hard to believe that this group is so small, LT, mainly because of, you know, what they've accomplished during their time here. You'd think there'd be more kids that have contributed to this run.
But you say 11, but with Nick being one of those 11, we're assuming he's going to get a medical redshirt and be back for a second senior season. But you're right. So I just think that, you know, what that tells you again, Brian, is a little bit about the program. You know, these guys came after, you know, the 2013 team that was so good for so long, and then that just builds everyone up behind them. A lot of young kids have played and contributed and played well to get the Bison in the position they are today, and hopefully looking forward.
North Dakota State coming in, they've really survived a gauntlet, tough games on the road, at home last week against Youngstown. Indiana State really doesn't fall into the category as a team that you look at as a gauntlet game. But at the same time, last regular season game, you still got to get up for them here this afternoon in a game that really does matter for North Dakota State to finish strong, to maintain where they are right now in the standings, and not only in the conference, but also the national picture looking ahead.
Exactly, and especially with Indiana State coming in, one of the things that Coach Kleiman said to this crew early in the week, remember the game, and we'll call it the Jensen game, when Brock gave the two pick sixes and they lost here that broke the streak and all that stuff. That came against Indiana State. So the Bison can't afford to have that happen today. Indiana State has given up a lot of yards on the ground, especially the last couple of weeks. But I think the number one thing offensively, the Bison want to have look good, the pass game today.
Try to pick that up. We talked about the run game, LT. Some people talk about it's maybe not as effective as it's been in the past. Well, when you look at the numbers, the running game has been as good as it's been ever in the past. Over 200 yards in almost every game that they've rushed this season.
8 of the 9 games that the Bison have played, they have been 194 yards on the ground or more, and 6, as you said, over 200. I kind of looked back at that stat earlier in the week and, you know, jumped back a little bit. I was a little surprised because you're right. We're probably not giving the run game as much credit as we should.
Defensively, North Dakota State, once again, they gave up some yards in between the 20s and really in between the 10s last week to Youngstown State, but the red zone defense the last month has been so good that getting into the red zone may not be as difficult, but scoring touchdowns for opposing offenses has been extremely challenging.
And to take that even a little bit shorter, is the red zone against the conference games and the 6 conference games, only 26%. Opponents scoring touchdowns. Fantastic.
Really, really good. And North Dakota State last week again didn't run as many plays as Youngstown did. The Penguins actually ran almost 30 more plays in that game, but the Bison only gave up 3 points. Just the one field goal in the first half. Cam Peterson on for another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff, and he boots this one to the back of the end zone and out, and that is just the 7th touchback of the season for Cam Peterson. And we will take a look at the Shield starting lineup for that Bison defense.
Bradley Rochas, DePere, Wisconsin. Grant Morgan, Oshkosh, Wisconsin.
Aaron Settle, Carlos, Minnesota. Greg Menard, Lakeville, Minnesota.
MJ Stumpf, Harvey, North Dakota.
Matt Plank, Gardner, Kansas.
B.R.G. Tucker, Belleville, Illinois.
Jalen Winbush, St. Petersburg, Florida.
Robbie Grimsley, Hutchinson, Minnesota.
Trey Dempsey, Lakeland, Florida.
Dylan Allison, Papillion, Nebraska.
So how about this? We have a different quarterback than what we thought we'd see. Aaron Young, the transfer from Wyoming, getting his first start here today for Indiana State. Inside handoff goes to Genesee. And Roland Genesee, a big bruising senior running back, 225 pounds, gained six up to the 31.
Very much a surprise, even coming from some people we talked with from Indiana State. Yeah, they were surprised he was in it in the starting lineup.
Indiana State offense, lineup brought to you by Shields. We expected to see Isaac Harker, but again, it's Glenn. Offensive line has had some issues. Keep an eye also, though, on Robert Tanya Jr., number 18 there, wide receiver. Very, very talented young receiver as Genesee gets the call and gains a couple. He's short of a first down by just two.
Sycamores have used three different backs routinely in that tailback running back position. Genesee has gotten the most carries and he has the most yards, averaging over 5 yards a carry.
A lot of junior college transfers on this Indiana State squad, and Genesee one of them from Glendale College. It's where he transferred from, originally from Memphis, Tennessee. And we're in the Wildcat here on third and short. Four men in the backfield here for Indiana State. Genesee gets the handoff and he plows ahead for a first down to the 36. You saw Kelvin Cook was lined up behind center. He's actually a wide receiver. A Miami of Ohio transfer, and Indiana State going quick tempo once again.
Same
Cook
book.
Is gonna keep it. This time he's gonna be buried in the backfield. Six defensive players were there. Brad Ambrosius was the first. One of those 11 seniors, loss of three.
Yeah, Brambrosius not fooled at all. He did not give up his outside contain, turn that play in early. Really good read by Ambrosius. You see him just kind of get his wide base. He made the read. Who's got the ball? Well, I'll go to him and not let him outside. Nice job by the senior, Brad Ambrosius.
Indiana State just 201 total yards at Northern Iowa last week.
It was bad. It was not. They did not look good in any form or fashion.
A demoralizing loss from the people we talked to with the Sycamores this week. Swung out, Young. Caught. Boy, pretty fancy footwork in the open field by Samson Levingston, one of the senior receivers from Indianapolis. Gets about half the yardage back that he needed, up to the 41.
Well, Robbie Grimsley, the safety on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, you see him try to break down, and Livingston did a good job of making first man miss. If you can make first man miss, that's your goal in a one-on-one situation.
Third and five from the 41. Glenn, quick drop, swung out in the flat, incomplete. Genesee, the intended target. I don't think he would have gotten to the first down marker anyway. And the Sycamores in a punting situation.
Yeah, McClendon, the tight end, was in the slot. It was his job to try to make the block to keep that first guy off. He whiffed on the block. So yeah, you're right, Brian. If that's a clean catch, it's not going anywhere.
So Thomas Bolden, another junior college transfer, originally from Brea, California, from Fullerton College is where he initially started his career. Boots this one away, pretty good punt. And Darius Shepard sneaking away, and Shepard almost lost the ball, and now he's going. He's got a block in front. Darius Shepard is gone. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
How nice is this? If you're the Bison, you haven't run a play yet. You've got 6 points on the board, and the ball pops loose, and he corrals it. And as soon as Shepard got to that ball, after he had it bobbled a little bit, there was nothing but green and a punter in front of him. And you can expect that he's going to beat that man and take it all the way. Darius Shepard can hurt an opponent in so many ways. This time, it comes in special teams.
So Darius Shepard, way to get the Bison on the board. Just like that, 84 yards on the return. extra point down and good as it's booted through from Peterson. And North Dakota State quickly responds on special teams. 7-0 NDSU on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Darius Shepherd almost lost it. Caught it in midair, and a good thing he did because he had a wall of blockers in front of him. And LT, this is the third straight week Indiana State has given up a punt return for a touchdown.
Yeah, that's just a crazy stat. You usually don't give up three all year, and then one in the last 3 weeks in a row. But great start there by the Bison and the special teams play. Eric Bachmeyer making the last block to clear him.
And the punter initially didn't even move. I think he believed that the ball was down or didn't see him. And at the last second, you saw Bolden try to come in. But again, three green jerseys in front leading the way. And time for another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Bob Pugh has been sidelined with an ankle the last few weeks, and he's going to get an opportunity here. Good special teams tackle.
That's Polanski.
Daniel Polanski coming in, and Indiana State backed up to their own 13. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Here's Pugh trying to make a move. He slows down. Polanski doesn't bite on either side. Open field tackle, one-on-one special teams. Well done.
Another local young man from Gatsby, Minnesota. Played his high school football for Grigla. Here's a look at Aaron Young in your quarterback comparison, brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. Not a lot for Aaron Young. He's just thrown 11 passes and completed 6 of them. Well, of course, now 7 with the one he completed today. Inside handoff, pretty good room this time for Genesee, who tiptoes through the line and taken down by Grimsley after a gain of 6.
Main reason he picked up those 6, the Bison had a little cross, a little work up front. As you see Ambrosius on the left side trying to work his way inside, running a little X with his defensive tackle, and the right play call and the right read made by the Sycamores.
Hand off again to Genesee, finds a crease, follows his blocks. And Grimsley kind of came up to close the hole, short of a first down by just a couple of yards.
Well, the Bison defense coming into this game, I think, Brian, feels like it doesn't have to do anything special or unique in terms of a game plan against the Sycamores offense. It's kind of a line it up, don't get too fancy, don't get yourself too far out of position, play straight up and you'll be all right. I think that's the thought process heading into today.
The Sycamores certainly known more as a throwing team. They're only averaging 118 yards on the ground, but they've really tried to keep it on the ground here in the early going. Young, quarterback draw, spins off a one tackler and across the 33 to the 34, enough for a first down.
I think it was Stumpf that had a chance to get him in the backfield. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, a little ISO here on Young. Yep, that was Stump. I think that he spins off of and then finishes that run hard enough to get the first down.
And North Dakota State again without Nate Tangway for the remainder of the season. Tore his ACL last week against Youngstown State. So going to be a by-committee approach for the defensive tackles. Boy, Bison really stack up that run well. No gain on the play. First carry of the day for Dimitri Taylor.
Defense coordinator Matt Entz did tell us when we talked to him this week, yeah, we don't have Nate Tangway. We understand that, but Matt said, hey, we're not going to scrap what we do. There just has to be a deeper rotation with Steidel and Morgan and Williams, among others. You can see Caleb Butler, 95, in at a defensive tackle spot right now. You know, Caleb's not big. He only goes about 240, but he understands leverage. He was an outstanding high school wrestler, and that really helps sometimes on the interior hand play and things like that between the offense and defensive lines.
Empty backfield here on second and long. Young across the middle, tipped and batted away.
I think it was Butler who we were just talking about. I think Caleb got his hands on that one.
Third and 10 coming up. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Butler up the middle, left hand up, deflect the pass away. Young, as you mentioned, you know, came from Wyoming to Terre Haute, and of course Wyoming has some ties to this place, this building.
Bison bringing an extra pressure. MJ Stump flattens Young back at the 21.
Cole Kars, I think, Brian, was also in on that play. It's good to see Cole back. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Indiana State has given up a ton of these this year. That's the 33rd sack allowed.
Boy, Menard, Kars, all sorts of guys, LT.
Yeah, they just dial up the pressure. Played a single high deep safety and just said, go get him.
So Bolden on for a second punt. Hangs this one up much higher, and this time Shepard will call for the fair catch. Oh, and he was hit.
There's a flag.
Dangerous.
Yeah, Dante Jones didn't see the hand in the air.
Coming in low on Shepard.
There's Coach Sanford. He must not have saw it either, but yeah, the hand certainly went up in the air, and Shepard did ask for the fair catch.
Kick catching interference. Number 19 on the kicking team. 15-yard penalty. First down.
You're right, Brian, that it was dangerous the way he came in low on those legs.
So 15 yards to the end of the fair catch, and that'll move the Bison all the way inside Indiana State territory. And we will take a timeout and be back with more. The offense on the field for the first time for North Dakota State when we return. 7-0 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. North Dakota State, first offensive possession after the punt return for a touchdown inside Indiana State territory at the 48.
Sycamores will play man-to-man on the outside. They put those corners on an island.
Play action. Stick wants to take a shot deep early. One-on-one coverage for Zendowski. Incomplete. Ball hung up there for a bit on Easton. Here's a look at your starting off offensive lineup brought to you by Shields for NDSU.
Easton Stick, Omaha, Nebraska.
Colin Connor, Mineral Point, Wisconsin.
Zach Johnson, Apple Valley, Minnesota.
Austin Cooner, Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
Jack Plankers, Leonard, North Dakota.
Landon Leckler, Beach, North Dakota.
Connor Wentz, Dunellen, Florida.
Chase Morlock, Moorhead, Minnesota.
King Frazier, Kansas City, Missouri.
RJ Erzendowski, Omaha, Nebraska.
Darius Shepard, Blue Springs, Missouri.
And King Frazier did not play last week because of a cartilage issue in his ribs. Back in the lineup this week, running strong in his regular season finale here at home, game six.
I like how Coach Polasek said, though, we did during scout team work tell the scout team to go hit him a little bit and then told Frazier to go hit them just to test those ribs.
Here's their Shield starting lineup for that Indiana State defense. They play a lot of different guys. The one to watch is Jameer Thurman. He's got 30 more tackles than the next highest tackler, Solly Lowe, on the team.
And Colin Cassidy. Those are the two top defenders for the Sycamores.
Cassidy really has not played or practiced much. Boy, that ball right on Erzendowski, and RJ got his hands up to make the catch and has a first down to the 26. And we finish the thought on Cassidy. He has not practiced all week.
For a couple of weeks.
But he still played. Beth Uhl on the sidelines for us. Beth.
Hey guys, a little bit of an anniversary for quarterback Easton Stick this week. This is the first team he ever got a career start against playing for NDSU. He told me this week that it's been a lot of fun going back and watching that film and seeing just how far he's really come. Last year, he accounted for 250 yards and three touchdowns against Indiana State.
All right, thanks so much, Beth. And Easton finds an open Jeff Ilias in the flat. Enough for another first down up to the 16.
Low, the free safety, playing really pretty deep, and given this position, he was probably 15 yards back when the ball started. See number three on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay on a back pedal. Little stick route here, run by Ilias. 10 yards, stop, first down.
Solly Low, a local Terre Haute resident.
There's Easton's numbers for the year coming into this game.
Brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. That quarterback comparison, exactly 1,500 yards coming in. And Stick on the quarterback keeper. All sorts of room. Touchdown.
Beth mentioned the three touchdowns he scored in his first start. Two of those were rushing touchdowns against Indiana State last year. This one looks really easy as he picks this one up. Stick at 124 yards rushing in that victory last year. And the Bison on their first offensive possession score their second touchdown of the day.
Boy, just five plays, for North Dakota State to move down the field 48 yards to add another touchdown. Peterson, the extra point is up and good. And NDSU up quickly, 14-0. We'll be back to the Fargo Dome with more first half action. Mike Sanford in his fourth year at Indiana State, a 1978 graduate of USC, has been all over the place, has coached a number of different places, including Utah, where he coached Alex Smith, starting quarterback in the NFL.
Yeah, he's called the plays at places like Stanford and Louisville as well. He's the head coach at UNLV. His son, same name, is the offensive coordinator at Notre Dame right now.
And I believe just had a child last week, a couple weeks ago. Time for another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kickoff your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Bob Hugh driven back in his own end zone, going to bring it out. Taken down at the 10-yard line. Boy, the Bison getting after it on special teams here today, and that was Jackson Brown, the redshirt freshman safety.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Brown playing the head hunter, coming down, just getting enough of that left leg from Pugh to knock him down. I tell you, Brian, this is a very important possession coming up here for Indiana State.
Here's your Bobcat game recap. Five plays, 48 yards in just under 2 minutes as Easton Stick runs it in from 16 yards out. As you mentioned, LT, just to stay on the field here and drive something together is going to be important for the Sycamores.
Yeah, the Sycamores have to find something positive. So far, it's been all negative. They've gotten a first down, but had to punt the first two possessions. You give up a touchdown special teams. Your defense gives up a touchdown on first possession. Now I think this is an important couple of minutes.
Genesee falls ahead for a gain of three. Bison again doing a pretty good job in the interior. We see Jack Darnell in the game. We're going to see a number of different defensive tackles. We alluded to that earlier, but I think when we talk to Nick Gazer, we talk to Matt Entz this week, it's going to be much more situational of when guys are in the game. First and second down, third down, all those different types
of things. Yeah, when you saw Butler and Cars in that last time, they were in there on a third down passing situation. Here it's still second down, or even that first down run type of thing. You got the bigger kids in there.
Young to throw, quick drop across the middle. Ooh, big tackle.
And who set the tone last week with his hit?
Tucker.
Pierre G. Tucker set the tone for that game early on for the Bison physicality on defense with that big hit. And here on a little shallow crossing route, he went nowhere.
Chiquette McClendon, the tight end, his 14th catch of the year. Again, Tucker really decimated by injuries his first 2 years in the program. He's had a really good junior year and a really, really good senior year.
Yeah, I think he's really thrived. He's shown his versatility. He's been in that kind of a nickel back position, which is kind of where he's playing now, even though it looks like he might drop down into the box. He's going to come in on a blitz.
Tucker got there in time as Young goes down again. And the Bison defense are teeing off on this Indiana State offense early.
Well, no one picked up Tucker on that particular instance. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. He's coming in free. Stanley Jones on an inside rush from across. Takes care of the guard. No one is there. There's no running back there to try to help out. The running back steps up, looks off to his right. The blitz pressure came from the offense's left. Easy pickings there for Tucker and the Bison defense.
Third sack of the season for Pierre G. Tucker, the senior from Belleville.
That's one thing we've noticed so far, I guess on tape too, but so far today, the offensive line for Indiana State does not get to the second level much. The linebackers have been free.
Shepard calls for the fair catch near midfield at the 49.
Second possession for the Bison offense, and it's a really short field to take care of it or take over.
Saw the Bison take a shot early, and Tim Polasek, the offensive coordinator for NDSU, told us That's something they wanted to try to do early because these corners, as you had mentioned earlier, LT, are left on an island quite often in this defensive scheme.
Yeah, and as a position group, Coach Polisek said, he told the guys that, you know, they have to pick each other up. And, you know, even if it's not a perfect pass, go make the catch. Because believe it or not, the wide receivers have not caught a touchdown pass since Missouri State. It's over a month. Sounds weird, doesn't it?
It does. It's really been the tight ends, the running backs, and others. Back to power this time. Frazier tiptoes ahead. Gains three across midfield.
Yeah, Indiana State will try to defense power like most other teams in the Missouri Valley attempt to, and that's by spill the defensive end. Try to get the play side defensive end down into the play as hard and as quick as possible.
This Indiana State squad really started off the season pretty well. Had a big Valley win against Illinois State the first week.
Offense was productive in the loss to the Gophers. I mean, so, you know, but Tanyan had three touchdown catches in that one.
Done. Nice job on the backside pursuit by Kenyatta Rollins, bringing him down, but still a pretty good gain there of four up to the 46.
Nudak Mutual Insurance replay. Wentz, the tight end, in there as the lead blocker from his fullback position.
Solly Lowe, again, a guy we will see a lot of across the field. He plays a lot of different places, makes a lot of plays for Indiana State.
And here's a spot the Bison want to improve on. Third down. First down, second down production have been okay. Third down lately has been somewhat of an issue.
Stick. Fires in the flat. Got it there just in time and enough for a first down. The reception made by Shepard as he gets just across the sticks to the 42.
Well, after Shepard ran the punt return back, we talked about his versatility. We've seen Shepard run jet sweeps for touchdowns. Here we see him working in tight quarters in the slot. He's been a wide the wide guy too on the receiver situations. Sets down right at the yard marker. Stick gives him the ball in a catchable position. A little bit high, a little bit to the outside. Got his hands on that ball and a Bison first down.
Boy, Devin Brockington was right there on the coverage.
I mean, the Bison third down averaging 42% on the year.
Play action for Stick. Rolling, firing on the run, off the hands of his intended target, Dallas Freeman, incomplete. Coverage on the play by Rondell Green.
Good job by Stick to get those shoulders squared away and get that pass downfield just a little bit high, sails a little bit high. Isolation on the route here, run by Freeman. Doesn't quite get the hips turned as much as he would like from the corner. Rondell Green was right there to help make the play even though the pass was a little bit high.
So second and 10 coming up here for North Dakota State. Stick gonna take off and run with it. Blocking to the outside. Goodbye! Unless Thurman can catch him. No! Stick, touchdown.
Similar play to the touchdown he scored earlier. The bound, there's just nobody left on the boundary. Boundary meaning the narrow side of the field or the short side of the field. Leckler with a nice block. He gets Thurman to overrun the play. Touchdown. There's just nobody back there to help out from the defense. So obviously Stick's getting his team in the right read, comes to the line of scrimmage, looks over things, sees that the safety is overplaying to the wide side. He'll take his shot to the right.
42 yards on the touchdown run for Easton Stick in North Dakota State with 2:04 to go in the first quarter. Have expanded the lead to 21 as a flag comes in.
Well, unfortunately for the Sycamores, this is more of the same in which they saw their defense.
Offsides. Defense number one. That penalty is declined. Result of the play, good field goal.
So offsides in Indiana State obviously declined there.
But just to go back to the point, Indiana State has given up a bunch of yards on the ground lately against, you know, physical teams. UNI is a physical team. Youngstown's a physical team. And we all know that the Bison's certainly a physical team. And so far right now, it's looking easy on the ground.
Let's take a look at our new seed fan cam. Always some colorful characters here at the Fargo Dome. NDSU at South Dakota next weekend, and then the Bison, if they take care of business, hopeful they will get a bye week before starting defense of their title run here in Fargo the following week after Thanksgiving.
Yeah, a little unusual that this is the last game of the year for Indiana State, and the reason for that is because the Sycamores are hosting the National Cross Country Meet next week, and so they moved the football game, I think it was with Illinois State, up. So they've played 11 weeks in a row, no buys. That's tough.
That's tough, especially the FCS where you just don't have the depth. Fortunately, the Sycamores have really not been hit by injuries too bad this year. Pugh bobbles the return for a moment. Boy, he's just not had any room. The Bison have smothered up again. All sorts of green jerseys down there making plays, and that time Dan Marlette got in to make the final stop.
Yeah, but Polanski does his job again. You can tell that the Sycamores want to have the return to the offense's right. But there's Polanski, 15, making sure that he kept that play, bellied it out. Anytime you can get a special teams runner, kickoff, punt returner, going sideways as opposed to upfield, you're doing your job.
One other player that actually got out on that tackle was Eric Perkins, who is
good
out here
him.
Playing today. He still has a cast on that hand where he broke his thumb, but an opportunity for him to fill a need on special teams, which is a concern Chris Kleiman has had. They've been very, very thin on special teams with some of the injuries they've had.
Well, we know what Perkins has done from special teams in the punt return category, because that's
unsportsmanlike conduct foul.
Ugh, and an unsportsmanlike to boot on Indiana State will back him up inside their own 10.
But, you know, you're right. Perkins is not going to be back there with his broken thumb catching punts and that type of thing. But he is going to be out there trying to make tackles, so it's nice to see him back.
But when you look at field position starting, it has been really bad for the Sycamores here today. Inside handoff. Boy, not much room to roam. First carry of the day for Jaquan Keys, sophomore from Indianapolis, Indiana.
But the two linebackers, that goes back to my point with the offensive line for the Sycamores, they're just nobody coming close to the second level. Somebody pulls and gets in Menard, he crashes that down. So you got Plank in there. Stump comes free from the left side to get all the way across the back side of the offensive line to make a tackle for loss.
Second and 11. Hand off up the middle. This time, some good room for Keys as he runs for 8. Up to the 14, we'll bring up 3rd and short.
Most of the time, it's a zone with a fullback lead, or a tight end, whatever you want to call that. Certainly position, it's a hybrid position for Patanu, number 8, the Keys. Nearly enough for the first down, but again, Genesee and Taylor and Keys have been in kind of a three-person rotation at running back.
Robert Tanyan has not been targeted. The big wide receiver there in the slot on the high point side of your screen. Inside handoff and no chance. Loss of 2 back to the 14. Greg Menard, MJ Stump, a number of Bison got in the backfield that time.
I think Blake Williams was also back there. Let's see if we can catch all three of those guys in on this play. Williams with the first hit. And it just does not look good for the Sycamores. It didn't even appear, you know, like they could get that yard that they needed. And if you can't get a yard this early in the game, you're in trouble.
Boy, Bison got some pressure on as the snap made just before the end of this first quarter. Darius Shepherd, another fair catch. The Bison on another short field at the 43. And that will do it for the first 15 minutes. NDSU, a good start at home in their regular season finale here at the Fargo Dome. We'll be back with the second quarter after this on the KBOY KFYR Bison Network. Well, kind of a smog in the air here at the Fargo Dome. There's been so much scoring and the cannons have been going off, the fireworks, that there just has not been enough time for the dome ventilation system to catch up.
thought you were going to use the analogy of back when you go to concerts in the 70s.
You would know that. I wouldn't.
That would be different.
It's a different generation than I was a part of there, LT. Wow.
Just an observation. Fires have moved, I think.
Yeah, looked like it. Connor Wentz may have been the guilty party.
Prior to the delay of game, first charge timeout, North Dakota State.
Okay. Oh, a timeout for NDSU as the play clock was running down.
I didn't see Coach Kleiman come in and try to save the offense those 5 yards.
Another situation very similar to last week where the time of possession does not really tell the story of the game. North Dakota State's only had the ball for 4 minutes and 15 seconds. Indiana State's had it over 10 minutes. But the drive's quick, the special teams touchdown, and that's what's led to a lot of the skewed look in time of possession and total plays.
We'll take a look at this trivia and pick it up from here.
Here's a look at your trivia question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean Council and the North Dakota Corn Council. What is the average size in acres of an American farm? There are a look at some of the possibilities you can pick for your answer.
I'm going to pick that one. Let's see if I'm right.
You're pointing. You pointed another. Fan base can't see you, but I saw the one.
You and I will know.
Yep.
This will be the ninth, or the just the 11th offensive play for the Bison, already 100 total yards.
Frazier, room inside. Good backside pursuit by Jonas Griffith, redshirt freshman out of Louisville.
Looked like just an inside zone play, nobody pulling, just getting hat on hat, trying to move someone. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Let the lineman try to get an angle and let your running back pick the one he likes the most.
So Stick will bring the offense to the line. Good gain of 5 yards there on first down. You also see Bryce Mesner moving across the formation. First carry of the day for Chase Morlock. Gains 2 across the 50. We'll bring up third down.
Well, you'll see Thurman come up on the bottom of that pile. It was interesting talking with Tyler Wooten, the sports information director from the Sycamores this week. He said that it was really hard with Thurman to try to get photos, like still photos of him in action, because he was always at the bottom of the pile, which is a good thing. Hard to get the picture. But that gives you an indication of how many times he is in on those tackles. And, Brian, you mentioned his total tackles. Just tremendous.
Sharp young man, too. 3.6 GPA in civil engineering. In the flat, ball was a little bit short and a little bit low and incomplete. And that will bring up a punting situation here for the Bison. Lance Dunn, the intended target.
Yeah, Stick is not going to be happy with himself on this particular pass. His timing, it seemed like, was okay. His setup was quick, but look at him shaking his head. He gets really down on himself. He's hard on himself, much harder than the coaches or anyone else can be. He's striving to be perfect, and he wasn't
Coons
on that play.
Hanging this one up, fair catch called for at the 11-yard line. And again, the field position not really in favor of Indiana State as Rondell Green calls for the fair catch.
I mean, with the 3-touchdown lead, the Bison are already here in the second, early second, to have an opportunity to play a field position game.
13:35 to go in the second quarter. 21-0 your score on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Head. 21-0 North Dakota State here on Senior Day at the Fargo Dome. And Indiana State again backed up inside their own 20. They've been back there most of the afternoon.
Only 27 offensive yards in the first quarter for Indiana State.
Young out in the flat. Tanyan makes his first catch. Pierre G. Tucker on the coverage. Tanyan close to a first down, about a yard short.
Yeah, just flat out. People we talked with down in Terre Haute this week said that this guy needs to be targeted more. Robert Tanyan, 6'5", 220, senior. Came to the Sycamores as a quarterback, was converted to receiver, and he's a tough guy to guard inside that, in the slot.
Competed with Mike Parrish, who got the job, and Parrish, now his coach, is a wide receivers coach at Indiana State. Young in the flat, just trying to get rid of it. Intended target was Jaquette McClendon, incomplete. Third and short coming up.
Young had a couple of Bison players coming down on him. He got a little bit of happy feet, it looked like to me, and did not get his base down. Pass to the flat was not on target.
Here's an answer to your trivia question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean Council and North Dakota Corn Council. What is the average size in acres of an American farm? The answer is 434. LT way off the mark by 1,000 acres.
Way wrong. All right.
Oh, looked like Young was coming off looking for an audible. Direct snap to the running back, and he has enough for a first down to the 21. A little bit of trickery that time.
Well, again, if you're in the position Indiana State's in, there's no reason to hold anything back.
Genesee.
Direct snap there to Genesee. He's playing his final game, the senior. That was probably the best line surge that Sycamores have had so far today, so that little trick probably helped a little.
Young, pressure coming, throwing deep. Intended target was Clayton Smith, but Smith did not know where the ball was, and Young took a pretty good shot of the backside there by G. Tucker again.
Yeah, the ball was already almost at its apex when Smith started turning around trying to see where it was and if it was even coming his way, so he didn't even know the ball was in the air or in his direction.
Again, Young playing for Isaac Harker, who's had a really good season, 256 yards. He's been hit a lot the last couple of weeks, 19 touchdowns, 8 picks.
Yeah, Harker's just the 2 touchdowns shy of Parrish's single season record, so a little bit of a surprise, but you're right, he got beat up a lot the last 2 weeks.
Young rolling out. Dom Davis on the coverage, and that ball was incomplete, hit the turf. Samson Levingston was the target that time for the Sycamores.
That was the only place that Young could possibly go with the ball because Robbie Grimsley went to single high safety and then floated over to get in the coverage. So it's just a two-person route, short guy and a long guy. Short guy has one person on him, that's Davis. The guy on the high side had three Bison around him, and you don't want to throw that one at all.
Indiana State in a tough spot, third and long again. Bison showing pressure, and here they come. Jalen Allison got there, among others. And a big sack back at the 12-yard line.
Allison and Menard, you're right, Jalen got there just a split second quicker than Menard. Menard with a speed rush around the end. Allison splits the tackle in the end to get there. Here's Greg Menard. Cole Jurek, and once a Bison, did a deal with Ryan Gellner recently talking about the set point of how an offensive lineman, you try to beat him on a speed rush to his set point. That isolation replay was a perfect example of Menard beating the offensive line to where he wanted to be to set up.
Fair catch by Shepard at the 39-yard line. Pretty good punt that time by Bolden.
Give out a little shout out to Ryan. Those have been fun. That series they've been doing during the pregame shows have been pretty neat. Called Once a Bison.
Different looks with different guys from different generations. That's been the neat part, is really how the game has evolved. Different things that used to be done offensively and defensively. Mike Sanford hoping his defense could come up with another stop here and trying to get into halftime and make any sort of adjustments they can to play a little more competitively here.
I think the Bison have done a good job on Cassidy, and so far Thurman's the only one that's been making many plays.
Easton stick to Lance Dunn.
Look at who just made the tackle. It was Thurman again.
Thurman got in there. Again, we're talking about a guy that has nearly 90 tackles here in the full season. I mean, that's a lot of tackles for one guy to make on any team.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. We're talking about number 20. Interesting thing about Thurman, if you just look at his measurables, he's 6 foot, 225. He can go side to side. He's played very, very well. He's the type of athlete and type of linebacker that if he's 3 inches taller and 20 or 25 pounds heavier, he's being talked about for the NFL. He just doesn't have the body type.
Stick.
Ooh, got him.
Throwing back shoulder. Perfectly thrown ball to Darius Shepherd, who put on the brakes and hauls it in inside the 35-yard line.
Well, what's a nice thing as a quarterback when you have multiple options and multiple guys open? After the fake to Frazier, he's looking up the seam to Wentz. He could have gone there. And he also has, as you mentioned, the back shoulder. Zips it out to Shepherd. Nice gainer.
Phil Wilson on the coverage, the safety for Indiana State. Bison on the move again.
Almost a 4-4 stack look is kind of what it, nine players in the box for Indiana State.
Oh, room to the outside. Dimitri Williams, a great block in front for Morlock. And Chase inside the five, down to the three.
What happens when you load the box this hard and no one's there to make the initial stop? It is going to be a big gainer. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Plankers clears the furthest guy to the outside, and then it's just nothing but a bunch of turf. And Williams got Chase probably about another, what, 10 yards or so on that block?
He was driving his man back.
That is what Williams has done the best this year. He has been, his downfield blocking on long run plays has been outstanding.
Going Morlock, a 71-yard touchdown last week as King Frazier, another senior, looking for the end zone and comes up about a half yard short. Oh, and flags come in flying at the end.
And I think it's going to be some stuff with Cassidy. We'll see.
And this Conlon Cassidy, this has been an issue for him his entire career. A lot of personal fouls.
Bison almost get it into the end zone. Called pound power when the tight end comes into a power eye situation and then you run, pull the guard. So it's pound power is kind of what the Bison call it. Tom Mesner.
Yeah, Mesner from Mackville, North Dakota, played his high school ball at Dakota Prairie. And again, he's played at some different positions. He's worn some different numbers because of the positions he's been asked to play on the offensive side.
Yeah, it was Mesner tied up with Cassidy. And to be honest, I saw Cassidy kind of rolling on the turf and then throwing his hands in the air. And because he's been prone to getting a personal foul, I did the same thing you did. I made an assumption that it was gone number 99. It wasn't.
So that'll back the Bison up. First and goal at the 16. Back to the run game. Frazier, not as much room this time. Nice job defensively by Indiana State's
Cottrell Moss.
Yeah, Cottrell Moss, the redshirt sophomore.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Morlock cleans up the first guy. Plankers trying to get a block downfield, but Moss snuck in there to take care of Frazier.
Excuse me, that was second down, not first down. Dead ball, so that.
Oh, yeah, your play does count.
Play does count, so third and goal at the 12.
Well, you know you're going to have one-on-one on the outside. And Ilias now motions out to one-on-one on the near side.
Play action. Stick looking for Ilias. Looked like he had a chance at it. Ball looked like it hit him in the helmet. Incomplete. And an Indiana State defender is still down over where that ball was thrown.
Phil Wilson, I think, who came out to number 22 to guard Ilias. And I think you're right, Brian. Watching it first, off his hands, off his face mask. And then I think Wilson just kind of lands on Ilias's foot.
The training staff attend to Wilson, who is up on his feet now at least.
But if you're Stick and you do have Ilias in a one-on-one, the way that Ilias has been catching touchdown passes, why wouldn't you throw it his way?
Mike Sanford coming onto the field to check on his safety.
As Ilias has 11 catches this year, and four of them are touchdowns.
He's been one of those red zone targets that Easton has really looked to, and he's made some big plays when given those opportunities.
Yeah, and those four touchdown catches, tops on the team in receiving touchdowns.
Gotta love Jeff Ilias, Lidgerwood, North Dakota. Yeah, always wears a trucker hat out here in warmups.
He does. But he's done such a just a tremendous job getting bigger and stronger. His blocking has improved immensely.
So a 29-yard field goal attempt coming up for Cam Peterson. He was 9 of 14 on the season. Solly Loken flying in. Peterson still got it off and booted it through.
How did he miss that?
Excuse me, Rondell Green was the one that came flying through. Hopped over a couple of guys. And that didn't look like it had a chance. Take a look at one there, Rondell Green.
Right under his right arm.
Unbelievable. Good concentration by Peterson, still getting that thing up. To extend the lead to 24-0, and we'll take another timeout, 8:23 to go here in the second quarter. Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Oh, this one is fumbled and dropped, and Bob Pugh is in trouble. Gets back to the six, and that's it. And the field position problems continue for Indiana State. They have been in this position way too often here in the first half. Let's take a look at your Bobcat game recap. 7 plays, 49 yards, and 3:13. Peterson boots the 29-yard field goal through, but the personal foul, unsportsmanlike, maybe cost the Bison a touchdown.
Well, it looked like the first time that the Sycamores did not have the right return called, where Pugh had to run the width of the field. He was just looking straight up and never controlled it.
I think the one thing we need on the field is a football.
You think so?
I think we need a football out there to play the game.
Are you sure? Yeah, the Bison up over double digits in yards per carry, and because of all those sacks, Indiana State less than one.
Is there a penalty? Oh, there was. So they're going to re-kick. That was a break. I did not see the flag come out, but it must have come back at the 35 offsides, as North Dakota State had one of their gunners was across the yard marker before the ball was kicked, so we will do it over again.
Well, Coach Kleiman is asking what was it on or who was it on? He knows what the call was.
So Peterson will boot it away again from the 30-yard line. And I know one guy that's really happy about that is Bob Pugh. That was not well cleanly handled. He was only going to be up back to about the 6 or 7 yard line.
Yeah, other than just flat turning it over, that was about as ugly, ugly as it could be.
North Dakota State will head to take on South Dakota next week in Vermillion, and USD taking on SDSU in a big rivalry matchup in Brookings, 7-7 at half. So we will do the Peterson Farm Seed kickoff once again. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Pugh retreats to his own two. Bob eludes one tackler, still on his feet, and then pushed out of bounds at about the 22-yard line.
Morlock was there. Close him out, get him out of bounds.
You know, Chase Morlock isn't one of those guys that is going to go down in the record books with all these crazy stats. When you look at it in terms of value to a team, I don't know if there's a senior that has done as much at as many different positions over the years as that guy's done. Between special teams, tight end, fullback, running back, he has played just about any kind of role you can ask him to play.
Well, it's one of the reasons that he didn't redshirt was how effective he was as a true freshman in special teams. Yeah, he's done a little bit of everything. When you talk to the Bison coach especially, one of the things they'll talk about Chase is they just go, he's a football player, and he can play every aspect of the game.
Young, handoff, Dimitri Taylor gets what he can across the 25 to the 26-yard line, and Taylor, a guy that last year tore his ACL on the second play of the season, missed the rest of the year, has come back.
He He's come back and he's hit some big runs too. Mm-hmm. He had a 63-yarder against Western. But the Bison defensive line and any number of combinations of those guys who have been in there just have not allowed Indiana State to get any pressure up the field.
Inside handoff. Bison had that thing well read. Good job by Kayla Butler getting in there.
But it was three, I think it was Steidel too, but it was 3-on-5. The Bison only had three guys with their hands down. Little misdirection, counter back. Butler and Steidel combine on that. Can't be defended any better than that for guys who start to play in a three-point stance.
Bison have three down linemen here on third and long.
Three down, three linebackers, and a nickel.
We saw this a bunch against Eastern Washington earlier. That looks like the linebackers might come.
Both of them do.
And Menard is one of them.
Fumble.
Oh, yes, the Bison got it.
Menard has the football. That was ruled a fumble.
So Greg Menard lined up in a linebacker position, and then he came hard on an A-gap blitz and comes up with the turnover for North Dakota State.
Okay, let's check it out on the Nodak Mutual Assurance replay. Ball, yep, that is truly a fumble. Steidel was coming, Menard was coming, and that's just a free look there from Greg Menard on the ground to get the fumble recovery.
It has not been a good day for Aaron Young. 3 of 8, just 19 yards. He's been sacked 3 times, and now the fumble.
Now the Bison might get that touchdown that the penalty took him away from last possession.
Frazier net in the backfield. Kenyatta Rollins got back there to make the play. A flag comes in as well after a gain of 1.
Guessing holding territory on this particular play.
Get the call from the official here, sort it out.
Holding, defense, oh. Number 99, half the distance of the goal, first down.
Conlon Cassidy called for the penalty, and Beth Houle has a report for us. Beth.
Hey guys, as this game continues to get a little bit more chippy and a little bit more emotional for the Sycamores, the Bison sideline telling their players to not be selfish, remember why they're out here, and don't get caught pulling into those personal fouls and playing into the chippiness and emotion that Indiana State is garnering here.
All right, thanks, Beth. And yeah, it's really important because you certainly don't want to get anybody hurt or any sort of personal foul situation that might cost them participation for next week. Boy, another strong play on the backside. This team came flying in was Enoki Moala, freshman linebacker, making the play.
Playing more as the year has progressed. This is a strong, just a speed move. Gets in between the tight end and the tackle. And beats Frazier to the line of scrimmage.
In Indiana State, they will play a lot of different bodies. Guys in and out, different positions all the time. Easton Stick by himself back there out of the shotgun. He will fire it out in the flat. Shepard has enough for a first down, but comes up short of the end zone. Down to the 2. Jameer Thurman out there again making a play.
Yep, Thurman started out there in the slot. You see him take on Ilias, kind of beat Ilias there a little bit to keep him out of the end zone. But as you mentioned, Brian, it was indeed a first down.
Frazier, the single setback here on first and goal. Frazier into the end zone, touchdown. And the Bison continue to pour it on here at home with 5:09 to go.
It's that power or pound power type of a situation again. Tight end rolls in to make it a power eye to the left. Pull the backside guard and let your guys be physical up front.
K King Frazier, ninth rushing touchdown of the season, the senior from Greenwood, Missouri.
Bison have had a 1,000-yard rusher 13 years in a row, and King Frazier last year was the guy that did it with 1,156 yards. Jeff Elliott's coming up a little slow.
Yeah, he came up a little slow there, being helped off by the medical staff. Bobby Knodel, Bruce Pye, team doctor out there to take a look.
Checking out the ankle, I think, of Ilias, left ankle.
Peterson boots through the extra point. 31-0 your score, 5:09 to go here in the first half for Fargo, but we do have a flag.
We have a flag. Austin Kuhnert just got rolled by two or three of the Sycamore players, and might have been something a little extra in that.
Chris Kleiman having a conversation with one of the officials down there. Penalty decline, extra point good. 31-0 your score, and we'll take a timeout and be back with more from the Fargo Dome after this.
Get your horns out!
31-0 your score. Cam Peterson on to boot another one away after the King Frazier 2-yard touchdown. And instead of Bob Pugh, now Rondell Green back for Indiana State on this return. This one angled towards the sidelines, and Green comes up to get it at about the 13. Best starting field position of the day for Indiana State, up to the 26.
Yeah, Peterson continuing to work on his directional kickoffs, and last week he did a tremendous job of that. And here he puts it down inside the 10.
That's a good point, LT. That's something we talked a ton about. But those angle kickoffs for Darian Townsend, who's a very dangerous return man for Youngstown State, that really took them out of their element when they were trying to block things up on special teams in the return game.
Yeah, those are the types of plays that'll help, obviously, win you ball games that you'll never find in a box score, and you'll rarely have anyone even talk about it because, you know, when do you talk about kickers? Well, when they make a game-winning kick or when they miss something. You know, very rarely when you do something as simple as kick the ball off, but it was not that simple to do what he's been doing in those directional kicks.
Indiana State, 18 total yards on offense here in the first half. And a flag comes in.
Too many people on the field, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Offense, number 12, 5-yard penalty. First down.
No. I thought I was catching one extra, but I was obviously wrong in that department.
And Aaron Young has really not played very much. He's just appeared in two games. This is his first start. And he's 3 of 8 for 19 yards. Back to the run game, Genesee.
At the end of last week's game, after rotating Harker out because Harker was probably just one huge bruise, that was the most consistent, I think, playing time Young probably had all year.
Young fires across the middle, all sorts of green jerseys in that area. Robert Tanyan, the intended target, 3rd and 13 coming up.
Yeah, Young just needs to get rid of it a little bit quicker, but the Bison can easily afford to play and stay in nickel here because of what the defensive line has been able to do with pressure. Remember the last sack came with only three down linemen, three guys running, rushing? But NDSU can really have that advantage of the extra defensive back because the pressure's been so good. And you got Levi Jordheim in there. Looks like he might be coming at linebacker. He and Stump.
Chris Board is also in the game, and he's missed a lot of time with injury as well. Young across the middle. Quentin McCoy was in coverage there on Tanyan, yeah. And a flag comes in late.
I thought he was there a little bit early. And Tanyan comes up a limping a little bit, but McCoy was locked up one-on-one on Tanyan, and I thought he was there a bit quick.
So Quinn McCoy, one of the 11 seniors, a junior college transfer from Santa Rosa Junior College, originally from Dallas, Texas.
And he really played well when Wimbush had to miss a few games, you know, due to his concussion.
Yeah, really did not call his name much at Western Illinois, where he had to start for Jalen Wimbush and a very dangerous receiving core for the Leathernecks. Bison did a good job that night.
Yeah, Tanyan you saw on the far side getting looked at, but he did come up hobbling just a little bit. Not many first downs today for Indiana State. That one was via penalty.
Young firing in the flat, tipped, and I think it was still caught. Nice job getting his hand underneath it as Miles Thompson, a transfer from Kentucky, his first catch of the day.
That looked like that skipped between the hands of Menard. Menard gets up, oh, just got one hand on it. Nice adjustment to the ball in the air after it was tipped by Thompson. One of the knocks on Thompson is he's dropped a few this year, but he's had some big games.
Yeah, really
South
the game.
Dakota against
Southeast
Southern.
Missouri State.
Yeah, Simo was another one where he did well.
Actually had the game-winning touchdown reception with 10 seconds left in that game, like Simo. As Genesee picks up a first down up to midfield.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay to give to Genesee, and then works back toward his right and finishes hard to get that first down. Nice run.
Matt Plank got in there that time to slow down Genesee after a gain of two.
Matt Plank, after he came in and had to replace the injured Nick DeLuca, he's got how quick he shot up the tackle chart, though, getting all those reps in at linebacker. Second leading tackler coming into this game now for NDSU.
Young across the middle on target. Levingston made the catch at the 41-yard line, about a yard short of a first down.
Took a couple of hits, too, after making the catch, so Levingston knows he's trying to get upfield, trying to get that first down. Bounced off a couple of Bison and got a half a yard short. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Young gets the ball out on time here. Dempsey and Tucker hit him. He held on.
Inside handoff and room to run. A first down and much more. Jaquan Keys inside the 20, down to the 17. Biggest play of the afternoon by far for Indiana State.
Need a yard, you get a bunch more. Taking care of Stanley Jones on the edge. And then cuts across. He did a pretty good job there, I think, of setting up Dempsey, too, and using the one man who was out there to his advantage.
Full house backfield. Handoff. Keys to the outside. He's close to another first down, a couple of yards short to the five.
That was kind of weird. Looked like it was bottled up. A bunch of people kind of stacked right around the 10. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. And then see that group? And then it just pops kind of free to the outside, leaving your corner to make a must tackle. Jalen Allison keeps him out of the end zone.
Excuse me, they give him progress all the way to the two.
Oh, he got the first.
Jalen Allison, as you mentioned, made the tackle. First and goal. Young gonna run. Young to the outside.
Wildcat.
Oh, excuse me, that is not Young. That is actually the wide receiver we saw earlier, Kelvin Cook, in for a touchdown for Indiana State. Cook following his blocks to the outside, bouncing it out, sneaking inside the pylon.
Well, some signs of life here for the Sycamores is kind of what they needed. A little speed to the outside. Stump gets caught up a little bit. MJ can't make the play. Nice little block.
Yeah, Dimitri Taylor really got a nice block on the outside linebacker that time, Stump. So really a drive that Indiana State desperately needed here at the end of the first half. Extra point is knocked through by Jerry Nunez, a true freshman from Naples, Florida. And it is 31-7 with 1:47 left until halftime. Talked about Cook, a transfer from Miami of Ohio. It's a tough package to defend, LT, when you put an athlete like him in there with Keys, who's had some big runs, Dimitri Taylor in there, and yeah, one of the tight ends as well.
The big tight end, too. That's Fatanu, the big tight end who wears number 8. Goes about 260, 265 pounds in there. Help leading the way. Not really much MJ Stump could do on that. I mean, he had two guys on him. Tough to keep your hips and yourself clear enough to be able to make a move on a ball carrier.
65-yard drive that time for Indiana State. Dimitri Williams, the sophomore, back ready to receive this kickoff for NDSU. Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Williams from his own 2. Dimitri had a big one last week. And Williams stays on his feet up to the 29-yard line.
But you just go back to where the point of first contact is made and then how many positive yards do you make after that? Williams gets about 10. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. There's first contact. And about 9 yards after that first contact. Good job by Williams.
Solly Lowe thought he had him and then had to go back and get him again. You know, Lowe, an interesting story too, LT. His brother was an All-American fullback at Indiana State. His family owns a construction company in Terre Haute. As we look at the average starting field position, and boy, a big difference there. Inside screen, Morlock steps out of one tackle. Flag comes in. Would have been close to a first down, but again, this may be coming back.
Well, there's multiple penalties called by... I thought one of them was a hat. Actually, it's one of the Bison shoes.
Offense, number 68, 10-yard penalty. First down.
Zach J. Johnson, the young Zach, redshirt freshman out of Blaine, called for the hold.
He was out. 78 plankers. See, I think, who they called. Here's the game recap. Best drive of the day, easily, for Indiana State.
Yeah, I didn't see things. Big Zach was on there, unless they were looking at possibly Landon Leckler, 78 instead of 68.
Yeah, I don't think. The initial.
Yeah.
It's hard to call him big, you know. Young, I guess young Jack. I didn't think he was out there on that play. Mm.
Williams to the outside using a block. Gaining about 5 up to the 24.
Yeah, Williams, if he can turn the corner before, in this case, the linebacker Cedric Doxey can get there, then it's going to be a big gainer because there is one blocker out there already. Doxey flowing. You see him flow. There's the block
Frazier.
Made.
King
Frazier trying to make the block.
Timeout Indiana State is Mike Sanford's thinking he wants to conserve some time here. Beth Houle, our sideline reporter this afternoon, has a report, Beth.
Hey guys, if you pay attention to this Bison coaching staff today, you'll see some of them are wearing some hats you might not have ever seen on them before. These are part of a national organization called Operation Hat Trick, partnering with 47 brand hats. They're honoring veterans and military. Proceeds from the purchases of these Bison specific hats will go to help wounded veterans and active military. They're selling them at Shields, the NDSU bookstore, and One Herd around town. An exciting moment for Bison football to be able to partner and honor their veterans.
Thanks so much, Beth. And yeah, the Bison also donated 100 tickets to veterans for this game today.
Completed pass to himself. Yep, stick with a completed pass to himself. It got bounced right back to him.
And he's going to lose a couple of yards.
But he's got a pass catch now.
He does have a reception. Happened the same thing in the Vikings game last week. Sam Bradford caught one of his own passes.
Here it is, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Comes right off McGowan, the nose guard. Stick trying to get some yards out of it. To follow up a little bit on the tribute to Veterans Day that Beth was talking about during one of our breaks earlier in the first quarter, Tiger Lily, the group from the Slaybaugh's from Hazen, saying God bless America. That was in honor of our veterans as well who are at this game.
Actually sang the national anthem at the first ever regular season game at the Shields Center just across the way for the men's basketball team as NDSU took on Arkansas State, the Bison 10-point victors over the Red Wolves in their opener. Women play Dickinson State tonight at 7 o'clock. Third and a long way to go here for NDSU. Third and about 16. Hand off to the outside. Well short of a first down is Chase Morlock as he gets to the 27, and Mike Sanford's going to call his last timeout with 42 seconds left.
Try and see if he can get something to happen here in the closing seconds. Devin Brockington, the corner, playing off the block, coming downhill. And then making the tackle on Morlock.
Brockington, a junior college transfer out of Ellsworth Community College, originally from Daytona Beach, Florida.
I have been to Daytona Beach, Florida. Everybody but asked me, how was the beach? I said, I don't know. We went to the racetrack.
Mike Sanford, give him credit. He's not giving up here in this game. Calling some timeouts, giving his offense and special teams a chance to make a play here at the end of the half.
Well, no matter how the game is going for Indiana State, and you look in the upper left and you know it's not going well, but for these guys and these coaching staffs, and for Indiana State who's not going to the playoffs, you only have 11 opportunities, you know, to learn, to do things well, and to coach your kids and play your game. That's why Sanford's working on here, working on some special teams.
Jackson Kuntz hangs this one up, takes a bounce at about the 35-yard line and picked up by Green. And Green taken down from behind. Special teams coverage has been awesome today. And how about that guy, the long snapper, James Fisher, getting in there to make the tackle. Mike Sanford saying, I think that ball was touched. I think he might be right.
What? Well, was there a first touch? I thought maybe Marlette hit it, but.
And they're going to
They're going to go to first touch at the 38-yard line, 36-yard line, something like that.
Yeah, that's what it's looking like right now.
Sorry, James, you don't get the tackle now.
Just 31 seconds left. One thing that did do was run about 10 seconds off the clock, so that gives Indiana State a lot less time to work with here and no timeouts. Quan Keyes, the single setback here with Aaron Young.
Yeah, those Bison ends get in that almost like you're running a 100-yard dash start.
Across the middle, caught.
Good to see him back in the game.
Yeah, Tanyan, who was hobbled earlier, gains about 4 yards.
Now G. Tucker, who just made the tackle, is going to stay on the turf.
Now he's up. He will come off for at least a play. 20 seconds to go until halftime.
They'll bring Jordheim in as Tucker has to come off for the at least one play.
Looks like Pierre will be okay.
Levi Jordheim, number 45, the sophomore from Dickinson High. Levi had his year end on a knee injury last year. He had to rehab that in the offseason.
Young to throw again. Fires high and in. Oh, it's intercepted. How about that? Jalen Allison came up with it. And now the Bison, with 10 seconds left, have a chance to maybe run a play and get in field goal range. A flag is also at the bottom
of the field. That's a hold. Vermillion tackled Menard. That'll be a hold, so this will be, it'll be declined, and Allison's going to get his pick. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. See the tackle on the left side. That was Vermillion that just hauled Menard down. Nice ball skills there by Allison to make an adjustment on that thing in the air. So that's the penalty on the bottom part of your screen and the pick on the top part.
Offense, number 70. That penalty's declined. First down, North Dakota State.
And Young really airmailed that pass, looking for Bob Pugh. Nice adjustment there by Allison.
Excellent.
So Bison with the ball at the 43.
You know, after Allison's interception there, you know, coming into this year, what was the position group where there may have been the biggest question mark?
Corners.
I tell you, Allison and Wimbush have really matured into their jobs.
Stick fires on the comeback route to Shepherd, who gets out of bounds at the 28 with 5 seconds left. And that will give Cam Peterson a chance from about 45 yards to boot this one through.
Little soft coverage on the outside. Stick gets set in time. Good throw. Shepard's going to just see, maybe I can sneak past him, but if I can't get to the end zone, he has to get out of bounds. And he did his job.
So Peterson will line it up from 45. Down, up. Looks like it has enough leg, and it's right down the middle and good. The final play of the first half, Peterson. Good from 45, and NDSU extends the lead to 34-7 as we head into the locker room.
That's kind of the way the last half of the year has gone for Mike Sanford. He calls the timeouts and all this stuff to get the ball back, and it cost him the field goal.
Beth is with Chris Kleiman.
All right, Coach, a nice 1-2 punch there with the interception and the points. How important is that to have the last word going to the locker room?
Well, we needed it because we gave up a score we shouldn't have given up after a penalty. And then for us to get a ball back, good play by Jalen Allison. And the 3 points is big, so we get the ball to start the second half.
Things are getting a little emotional out there, a little chippy. How do you calm the guys down yet keep that intensity here?
Well, we need to be intense, but we got to be smart. Our season's going to continue on. Theirs isn't, so we have to be really smart.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thanks so much, Beth. And good point there by Chris Kleiman on that, LT.
Very good point. The Bison know that they have a future, and ISU knows that this is their last game of the year.
Well, stay tuned. The Proceed Halftime Report is coming up. Ryan Geller and Alex Egan will take a look around the Valley and have some first half analysis from today's matchup between the Sycamores and Bison. 34-7, your halftime score. We'll see you in the third quarter here in just a few minutes. Stay tuned for the Proceed Halftime Report. Back at the Fargo Dome, Brian Shawn, Lee Timmerman with you, and our sideline reporter, Beth Houle, had a chance to catch up with Indiana State head coach Mike Sanford.
All right, guys, joined by Coach Sanford. Coach, what's the mood like in that locker room? What do you say to them as you come out here for the second half?
Well, we had a bunch of things go the wrong way there in the first half, and we've got to find a way to make some plays. We got, you know, they're going to get the ball first. We got to stop them. We got to move the ball and score on offense.
It's your last game of the season. I mean, what do you say to the guys in there? What's the emotion like as they get ready for their last half of football on this season?
Well, we just got to keep fighting. We can't ever give up. Can't ever give in.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck out there.
Beth, thanks so much. And I know Mike Sanford in his fourth year, keeping spirits up, especially after what happened last week against Northern Iowa. Well, certainly going to be a challenge because, you know, when you're not playing for anything, there are some challenges involved with that, LT.
But even though it backfired on him, I think the fact that he did those timeouts showed to his team late first half, we're going to play to the end.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Dimitri Williams returns out to the 22-yard line. And then on the stop there is Brenton Lockett.
And others.
Jalen Bennett, yeah.
Yep, to step through that one tackle and get the 2 extra yards kind of cost him about close to 600 pounds of guys laying on top of him.
So Easton Stick will bring his offense back out. Let's take a look at his numbers. Quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. 11 attempts, 7 completions. Pretty efficient first half, 58 yards. Of course, he ran for 2 touchdowns as well. Ground game here. Good push up front. Chase Morlock gains 8 to the 30.
Especially in the first quarter of this game, the Bison just came out and showed that it was a physically better, more powerful team. So that you want to start the third quarter doing the same thing. Nodak Mutual Insurance, instant replay. You saw Morlock get what, probably close to 4 yards before first contact on some zone blocking. That just means your guys straight on winning. You're winning against your man. Man-to-man offensive line coach Riley has to like that.
Conlon Cassidy making the tackle 8 yards down the field. Oh, and a one-on-one win there for Lance Dunn in the hole as he runs through a tackle up to the 38. Dunn did really not see a lot of carries in that first half, just his third touch of the first of this game so far today.
Well, it's the safety low, number 3, who you're looking at. It's going to come up, get squared up, and then get beat. Physical end, good pad level there from Dunn to pick up the first down and a few more. But again, when your free safety is the first point of contact on a runner, your blocking scheme worked well.
Easton Stick to throw, has time, now going to take off with it. Stick across the 40 to the 44-yard line, gains 6 yards.
Well, he wasn't able to get the ball off, but he did everything else right on this play. First check is to his right. You see, watch his helmet. It looks, nope, don't like that. He's looking back to the boundary side, doesn't like that, finds a little opening. Then the best thing he does is he gets down right at the end before he takes a big hit from either of these guys closing in on both sides of him.
Mesner and Ellefson motion to the top of your screen. Back to the run game. Morlock steps out of a tackle. Morlock to the outside. And Morlock still on his feet inside Indiana State territory down to the 43. Good strong finish for the senior from Moorhead.
And this is a linebacker he's working against, Doxy. We pick it up after he's already physically beat Doxy. He picks up the first down here, and then you know Chase doesn't like to run out of bounds. He spins back in, gets what he can, and the Bison are already across midfield.
Yeah, Doxy, a transfer from Illinois, was really just a special teams guy there for most of his career. Had a chance to transfer and work on his graduate degree and start at linebacker for the Sycamores. Was actually a safety his career at Illinois. High snap, Stick handles it, gets it off, and Shepherd tried to make a play. No flag comes in as Devin Brockington had the coverage.
Bison fans are going to boo, but I don't think a flag should have been thrown. The timing of this play was blown up right off the get-go because of the fumbled snap. Defender has every right to that spot as the offensive player, and Shepherd in this particular case. Shepherd tried to run through him to get to the ball. I think that was a good no call.
Play clock down to 4.
Ilias back in. You know, he missed some time in that first half, but he's back in there now.
Play action for Stick. Easton with time. Not running out of time, but he has room. Inside the 30, Easton Stick to the 25, down to the 22-yard line before he's finally wrapped up. But Easton Stick continuing to make plays with his legs. The leading rusher for North Dakota State today, and he's getting near that 100-yard mark today.
I like the read. I think he's trying to get it to the far side to Lance Dunn, who ran out of the backfield into a deep vertical. It wasn't there. He tucks it and then gets, well, as you mentioned, Brian, close to 100 yards now rushing. Breaks to the outside, hoping Erzendowski can get one more block for him. But RJ couldn't block 3 guys. Good pickup.
Again, Easton Stick, 17 carries, over 100 yards rushing last year. And this pass behind Dallas Freeman, incomplete.
Safety coming on a blitz from that side, and a little double slant. Stick goes to the outside, and when you talk about passes on which he's been frustrated, these are the types of throws. That was not remotely close to being a catchable ball. That's got to be out in front of him, and it was way behind Freeman. Coach Polisek was hoping that today and next week he'd be able to get 15 completions without having to throw the ball 30 times. They're not going to get to 30 throws, I don't think, because the Bison have been physical.
Dunn, look at the movement up front by the Bison offensive line. And Dunn is going to be close to a first down inside the 15.
It kind of backs up a little bit about what we were just talking about. I think NDSU can line up and jam it right now, right down the throat of the Sycamores whenever they want to. But with the bigger picture in mind, there's some things in the pass game that the Bison want to work on. The pass didn't, you know, on the play before it doesn't work. You go to the power game and you show your physical strength right up the gut on a 9-yard pickup.
Third and a half yard here. Flip out to Dunn. Getting to the outside. Beats a man to the outside. Touchdown, North Dakota State. Lance Dunn from 14 yards.
Well done. Once Dunn gets to the corner, he did a really good job of getting and turning. I think he wants to take and see if he can work off of Plankers, the block from Plankers, or excuse me, not Plankers, Leckler. Leckler couldn't get in front of him, so Dunn decided to turn on the juice, make a real tight turn, and get upfield.
And the safety, Phil Wilson, could not get over to cut off the angle to the outside on Dunn, who showed off his speed, and now Lance Dunn, his fourth rushing touchdown of the season.
Again, when he got to the edge and turned, really tight turn. Good job.
Peterson on for the extra points. It's good. And the Bison have extended their lead to 41-7 with 11:07 to go here in the third quarter.
That makes everyone happy associated with the Bison. You can come out, you talk things over in the half. You know you're getting the ball. You've dominated the scoreboard in the first half, and you want to put one more on them in the start of the second half, and that's what Coach Kleiman's team just did. Well on their way to his 37th head coaching victory against only four losses.
And for the ninth time in 10 games, NDSU over that 194-yard mark rushing, now at 213, and we still got a long way to go in this game.
Again, depending on how much the bite or what we see for rotations, but, you know, NDSU could keep this first team in there and get that thing to 400 probably if they wanted to. I don't think we'll see that.
That's always the question mark with coaches. Yeah. When do you start getting your starters out and start inserting some of your backups here for reps?
Well, and also keep in mind that reps during practice have been diminished as well. There's more walkthroughs, more discussions, less full speed reps on the guys who have been in those starting roles and those, you know, heavy plays all year.
Jaquan Quees is back along with Rondell Green, and Green is going to have to come all the way up and take it at the 11. Green going sideline to sideline, and the green jerseys collapse in on him, taken down at the 24-yard line. Chase Morlock in there again.
Yep, another senior day again for NDSU.
Jake Brinkman, also redshirt freshman linebacker, got in there to make the stop.
You know, Chase Morlock makes that tackle right there, but, you know, I think another thing as we take a look at the QB comparison, I'll bring it up later. Go ahead, Brian.
Yeah, North Dakota Beef Commission quarterback comparison, 6 completions. Out of 13 attempts for 37 yards, the interception. He's also sacked Aaron Young 3 times in that first half. A lot of pressure on Young. Genesee pushes the pile ahead for a gain of 3 to the 27.
Well, I know there were some sacks and things like that that you were talking about, but I think NDSU's ability to keep the linebackers just clean all game has made it tough sledding in the ground game. But we go back to the seniors and we go back to Chase, and we talked a little bit about Morlock earlier, but he accepted his role and embraced it, and I think that's one of the reasons that he's been so effective in multiple ways for this team throughout his 4 years.
Genesee finds a crease up to the 30, gains 3 more, will bring up 3rd and 4. Greg Menard in on another tackle. He's been very active today.
Yeah, from the backside. He was the high side in, and it looked like the Bison had a big slant, or they anticipated or saw something in their reads that showed that the play was going to be off to the defense's left, All four guys slant right into that motion. That's why on that zone stretch play, you only give up 2 yards. He'll take that all day long.
And again, they run the Wildcat here on third and four. And should have enough for a first down is Genesee. MJ Stumpf made the tackle, but they'd like to go to that Wildcat package with Kelvin Cook taking the snap, one of the backup wide receivers.
And Cook with the handoff, and then Genesee's able to kind of feel his way to the left and then finish it. I'm laughing because I saw Thompson come in the end of there and just give one of the defensive backs a stiff arm right to the helmet.
Young back in here behind center. Young firing deep, well underthrown, off target, incomplete.
I think the Bison safeties today, Brian, have done a really good job in pre-snap movement of not giving that guy, the quarterback Young, a really clean pre-snap read. Both Dempsey and Grimsley were moving, hopping zones, showing like they were going to come in the box, then pulling out and pulling back, I should say, and Young just threw it to nobody.
Clayton Smith looked to be the intended target that time. Young will keep it. Firing in the flat. Boy, nice throw on the run. And it is caught by Miles Thompson. Up to the 48 and up for a first down.
Well, he talked about the number of transfers in Indiana State. He's an FBS transfer. Thompson started at Kentucky.
Beth Hull on the sidelines has a report. Beth.
Guys, Nate Tangway obviously out after tearing his ACL in last week's game against Youngstown State. I had the opportunity to talk to him this week. He said that they're waiting for the swelling and his flexibility to come back, the swelling to go down and his flexibility to come back before they can perform surgery. He looks to have it evaluated on Wednesday again with hopes that surgery will be on Friday.
All right, thanks so much, Beth. And yeah, we talked about LT, the significance of a Nate Tangway on the defensive line. When you look at his stats, they're not going to blow you away. 25 tackles, a half sack, but that doesn't tell the story of what he has done for this team this year.
Yeah, no, it tells none of the story. He demands a double team on every play. They're going to reset the clock here, but Nate demands a double team to begin with, and he had all those production. And I just go back to, I think, what his best game was this year was in Macomb. Western. He dominated that game from an interior defensive line position, and that is very, very hard to do. And I think another thing is you've already seen in the course of when Tangway's gone, what, four if not five different guys play his position. That's how versatile he was.
Young is going to keep it, going to throw it to nobody, out of bounds. Tuska giving chase there from his defensive end spot.
Almost caught it, but not quite. Tuska made a lunge right when the pass was being thrown. Young went to the ground, got tripped up there, but Tuska using that pretty good speed. Here's the back end of that on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Tuska's hustling. He's given a lunge right when the ball is released. And like we've seen today, Young at times has had a inability to be accurate.
Aaron Young so far here this afternoon, 7 of 16 for 50 yards and an interception. There's a look at Nick DeLuca, another guy that's been missing for the last month and a half.
You know, and I know it's hindsight and you can say whatever, but the South Dakota State game where, you know, Christian went nuts, he doesn't have that type of day if
Nick DeLuca,
DeLuca is playing.
Question. Young fires on target, on time, and that's caught by Sam Levingston. Gain of five, up to the 47 of NDSU.
Just a shallow little slant right back into the teeth of the middle of the defense. Very little opportunity for him to break a tackle when you have Davis on him right away. Stump right there to force the third down.
Indiana State 5 of 11 on third down.
It's another one of those days where Indiana State just hasn't targeted their best receiver hardly at all. That's the guy in the slot, the first guy there, Tanyan, the big kid, set up on about the 48.
Young across the middle and caught. Nice job going and getting it that time is Miles Thompson, and he's right at the first down marker, should have enough.
Doesn't get much past that, the catch, but Allison tried to keep him a yard short of his of the line to gain, couldn't quite do it, but Allison makes a decent break. Thompson with a nice job of concentrating and holding on to that one. Jalen was right on it.
Young behind center again. Genesee trying to follow some blocks, taken down after a minimal gain of two. Beth Hool on the sidelines.
Hey guys, on the Bison sideline right now, as the NDSU defense is trying to take care of business, NDSU offense looking at making a switch at quarterback. Both Cole Davis and James Hendricks playing catch over here, getting ready to make their entrance, possibly on this very next NDSU possession.
Maybe see more of that at a number of positions too, LT, especially on the offensive side.
That's what we were talking a little bit about, and I think that opening touchdown of the of this third quarter, as we see Trey Dempsey coming to the sidelines. Did not see where Trey was involved or how he got hurt on that last play. Well, safety is not a position of depth.
Especially with Eric Bachmeyer still working back. He's not near 100% yet.
No, Eric's out there now playing safety, but with his knee, you're right. He's not 100%. Bachmeyer's the one nearest to you, standing on the 28. Movement. There's a good look at Eric, number 29.
Preston Collier, right tackle for Indiana State, called for the false start.
Bachmeyer, the sophomore from Kindred. They were hoping he would bounce back from his knee injury a little bit quicker than he's had. It's just taken him longer. His inline speed isn't bad, but he had to miss a lot of his reps on special teams over the course of the last few games.
Dimitri Taylor gets the call on second down. Gains four. Third and long coming up. Grant Morgan getting in there to make the tackle.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Check out the inside. Morgan playing off his block and helping make that tackle.
Getting word that they are looking at Trey Dempsey's neck down on the sidelines. Well, hopefully it's nothing more than a stinger for Trey.
It was kind of a strange the way he was humped over and coming off the field. Third and long here.
Taylor gets the call on a draw. Blocks pretty well, and he's got a first down up to the 31.
Showing flow to the wide side of the field and going back to the boundary.
Cole Kars just missed him there in the backfield. Back to the ground game, and this time the Bison not giving up a whole lot. Taylor getting another carry that time.
Inside, Pierre G. Tucker, who got picked a little bit on the play before that got the first down. Not on that play. He was in there, another one of the seniors.
Young, play action this time. Rolling left, firing in the flat. Bounced off his intended target out of bounds.
Ooh, not a lot of space to try to squeeze that one in there to Livingston. I thought Young was just about ready to run it here and get what he could, and then Livingston turns his head back to his quarterback. Thrown just a hair behind him with a bunch of hands between the quarterback and the receiver. Pierre G. Tucker in there on some flat coverage.
Young to throw. Bison bring pressure. Swung out. Wide open receiver is the tight end. Jaquet McClendon was left alone, and he has a first down to the 15. But a flag did come in late.
I don't know. I think it might be a hold. We'll see at the back end of this thing.
Personal foul.
Roughing.
Hands in the face. Offense, ooh. Number 73. 15-yard penalty. Replay the down.
So that negates the first down as Collier is called for the personal foul.
He's had his hands come up a little too high, trying to keep the Bison off his quarterback. But you're right, Brian Young, out of desperation more than anything else, because the Bison were coming hard with the blitz. Did get it out there in the flat, but costly penalty there for the Sycamores.
Collier, one of the seniors that's playing in his final game here today. And all of a sudden now, it's a long way to go for a first down. Indiana State all the way back to their Bison 44-yard line. They need the 21 for a first down. Young has time, fires, and caught. Miles Thompson makes another catch, well short of a first down, up to the 41, only gained about 3 yards.
Trying to circle around and hoping the sideline opens for him, and Dom Davis did not allow that to happen. That one is third and that much. You give him the soft stuff underneath and make a clean tackle. That's what Davis does here.
Indiana State will punt it away here on 4th and 20.
Shepard back, who provided the first points of the game today on the first punt of the game.
Thomas Bolden, kind of a wobbler down towards Shepard, who calls for the fair catch at the 16 and makes it. And that's where the Bison will have it when we come back. 3:31 to go here in the third quarter. 41-7 your score on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Take a look at our New Seed fan cam. Another capacity crowd of over 18,000 on hand to take this one in between North Dakota State and Indiana State today. Final regular season home game before we get rolling with what we think will be at least a couple of home playoff games. Done. Ahead for maybe 4 yards.
And it was Cole Davis who handed off to Dunn. So Easton Stick is... his day is done. He will get credited with another win as a starter, and he'll be up to 17-1. Will Stick as a starting quarterback for the Bison.
Easton Stick, 65 yards passing on 7 of 13. And he also ran 4 times for 85 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Now, so that's, where
he made his hay.
He did his damage on the ground. But Davis, the junior from Kearney.
Back to the ground game again. Not much room this time. No gain for Lance Dunn that time.
Little pin and pull, it looked like. Austin Kuhnert, after making the snap, trying to pull out and get out in front.
Tyshawn Waller got in there from his nose tackle position.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. That first initial penetration kind of took Dunn off his intended path. An outside tackle. Power look to the run game. Not an easy thing to do for a center, though, get that snap and then get pulled out in front.
Play action for Davis. Dropped off in the flat to Dunn, and he is upended nicely by Indiana State's Brenton Lockett, redshirt junior out of Fort Wayne. Flag comes in late.
They got flankers. No, it was on Jack, I guess.
Well, I think Ben Ellison was who they called it on. Pretty good closing speed. That time by Lockett for Indiana State.
Down.
It will be declined, which makes sense.
Yeah, to punt it, get the ball back. Bison in a fourth down situation now.
Rondell Green will retreat back to his own 40-yard line to take this punt from Jackson Koontz. Indiana State bringing some people that time, but Coons gets it off. Kind of a short punt. Taken by Green inside by the territory at the 49, and that's where they will have it when we come back. 41-7 your score with 1:37 to go on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services Score. Your score, 1:37 left here in the third quarter. Indiana State good field position. We'll start inside Bison territory at the 49.
Now Sycamores moved the ball fairly well last possession. Kind of shot themselves in their own foot when they got it down to about the 20-some yard line.
Young threw it in a spot. They're going to get G. Tucker for pass interference, and Miles Thompson looked like he was timed pretty well, but maybe Pierre there just a moment early.
Yeah, it's the backside guy who called it, who was looking at the play. Looked like Tucker tried to dip his shoulder in and separate right before the ball got there.
Defensive pass interference, number 37. That's a spot foul, automatic, first down.
Touch early maybe on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
So that'll move the ball about 3 yards and give Indiana State a first down at the 46.
Ben Young the whole way at quarterback.
Young play action again. Young Tuska giving chase. Can't get him. And Young gets to the sideline and out of bounds. Close to a first down. He's about a yard short. Maybe they did give it to him. Up to the 36. Yeah, I think he's got it.
That was almost a single receiver pattern. And one guy is running a deep, almost a post. So when you're running left, you're not going to get it 40 yards downfield over the middle. The other guy on about a 12-yard out was covered. So Young really had no choice but to run it.
Jaquan Keys picks up 4. G. Tucker in on another tackle.
Yeah, you're looking at Matt Plank, who was also in on that one. Matt's role, of course, went to supreme importance after DeLuca's injury. Stepped in, became that starting middle linebacker. Came to NDSU from Kansas, Gardner, Kansas.
Keys, 6 carries, 50 yards. That leads Indiana State so far here this afternoon. Young play action, looking backside, throwing all the way back across the field and out of bounds. Intended target was the tight end Jaquette McClendon, who just could not get a foot down.
No, McClendon did make a nice play on the ball in midair, catches it right up at the peak. I think that was Grimsley who was over there as well on the defense. Yeah, Robbie Grimsley. You see that 1 foot needs to come down in play. Was a little over a foot out of bounds.
3rd and 6. Boy, how about some of the footwork?
And
oh, the
pitch.
Flip. How about that to Taylor? And I think he got close to a first down, maybe a yard short, but that was a heck of a play by Kelvin Cook out of the Wildcats.
Yeah, Cook makes a spin right when Jordheim about has him wrapped up. And then the late pitch to get just shy. Of course, we saw Cook have some success. Not a conventional pitch. Uses that left hand to push it out. Menard still hustling on the play to make it a 4th and short.
Cook is going to stay in at quarterback here. 4th and short coming up.
4th quarter, 1st.
So that will do it for the 3rd quarter, and it's the 4th quarter, so hold up your 4 for the 4 for 4 from PetroServe USA. Get a pizza, 2 cookies, and a drink for $4 at all 24 PetroServe USA locations. We'll be back with the final 15 minutes from Fargo after this.
Get your horns out!
4th and less than a yard, and a flag comes in.
False start. Interior lineman. Oh, Indiana State has struggled to find much today. Their own worst enemy at times.
Young was put back into the game.
False start. Offense, number 77. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Matt Byrne, junior out of Chicago. Beth Houle on the sidelines as a report for us, Beth.
Hey guys, if you take a look at the officiating crew today, you'll see they're all wearing a microphone and an earpiece. That's for better communication. That takes away that need to huddle up and talk over a play. They can talk from anywhere on the football field. It's technology that's made its way into the NFL game, the FBS, and now we're starting to see it here at the FCS level. The referee's telling me they love it.
Indiana State going to take a timeout here and talk it over on fourth and six.
Personnel issues there. We're waiting for a guy to come in. He wasn't ready. Had to put his helmet on and then run in.
Well, again, when you're getting ready for fourth and short, and then all of a sudden got to get ready for a fourth and six, much different play call, much different situation.
Certainly for Coach Sanford, though, you know, you wouldn't change your mind, and just because you're fourth and six as opposed to fourth and one, you still stay on the field and go for it. I mean, after all, you're down 41-7.
Let's take a look at your New Seed fan cam.
Horns up.
Horns up indeed, LT. Last time these fans are going to get a chance to see NDSU here at the Dome for a while. Maybe December before they see him next.
Yeah, if it goes as the Bison hope it goes. That would, so you're implying a victory next week and then a bye in the first round after Thanksgiving, and then it's December.
It is December. South Dakota, the opponent next week, and boy, tied up in a tight one today with South Dakota State. Pretty good rivalry game there between the Jackson Yotes, 28-21 late in the fourth quarter.
We'll pack up all the equipment and head down to Vermilion and show you that one next week. Fourth down.
Menard giving chase. Young fires, caught. First down. Clayton Smith makes the reception.
Nice job on the roll. Again, he had a man open deep. That's Tynion, but with a roll away from your throwing shoulder, you just can't get the ball 35 yards downfield. Stuck it right in there for the first down.
First catch of the day for Clayton Smith, the junior. Junior college transfer from Fullerton College, originally from Necross, Georgia. Young rolling again, looking back to the far side of the field. Now he's got room to run. Inside the 20, slides down at the 16-yard line.
Yeah, he wanted to throw back and throw back into the deep corner, but because Pierre G. Tucker was playing in the flat and a deep flat, there was no way that Levingston could get the he couldn't squeeze it in there. So the coverage is deep, and then Tucker is back at about the 10-yard line. Pierre turns around, sees that the quarterback starts running, slides down. Very solid pass coverage there from your D-back and linebacker combination.
Gain of four that time for Young. Play action again. Young firing to the corner of the end zone, but ends up going into the student section.
They're fired up. Now he's throwing it because that early and that far, just to save himself.
He's fine.
It was a nice kick. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Look at the close here. Tuska coming down, and he's just getting rid of it. It was a clean catch. He had to battle his buddy for it.
Yeah, he did. And well, that guy's wearing a whale suit, so he is hampered a little bit.
I remember in indoor football, you used to keep them. If they threw it in the stands, you got to keep it.
Third and six here for Indiana State. Young swings it out, and it is caught. Dimitri Taylor could not quite get past the defender there, and he comes up short of a first down by a yard as Bachmeyer came over.
Yeah, trying to make just a little move and get up into the air. There was a flag on the far sideline. Here
it is.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Back at the 17. Watch 29. That was a pretty good pursuit there for Eric Bachmeyer.
Trips him up.
Offsides. Defense, number 90. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So they will take the 5 yards by penalty and get third down again instead of having fourth and one, which makes sense.
Bachmeier trips him up, gets a hold of his calf, and
third and one again, and once again, Kelvin Cook comes back in at quarterback to run the Wildcat. Genesee back there along with Taylor, along with the tight end, LaFail Fanatu. Cook outside. Boy, Cook is bottled up, and he's getting himself in even more trouble. There is nowhere to go. Back at the 24-yard line, he lost a bunch. 12-yard loss.
He lost that because MJ Stump at the point of attack took on two, if not three, Sycamores, closed the play off, closed the edge off. The man in the bottom of that, MJ Stump, tremendous job to force the reverse and no chance on that third down play.
So that will bring in Jerry Nunez for a field goal attempt from 41 yards.
That's a tremendous job there by MJ Stump.
Nunez has had a really good freshman year. 14 of 17, he's hit two from 46 for long. Jerry right down the middle of this one. Gets Indiana State on the board with 12:43 to go. First 3 points of the second half for the Sycamores, but they trail by 31. We'll be back after this.
Get your horns out.
And the defense on the sidelines after holding Indiana State to a field goal attempt there. Indiana's connection 41. Dimitri Williams back deep once again for North Dakota State. This one coming down at the 7, angle towards the sideline, and Williams gets back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage that time for Indiana State. Getting in there to make the tackle was Lonnie Walker.
Yeah, that directional kicking, what NDSU has done so well the last couple of weeks, that's exactly what Indiana State does fine right there. Not giving Williams any opportunity, kind of pinning him back into that corner and not allowing any lane to open.
Take a look at our trivia question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean and North Dakota Corn Councils. What percent of U.S. farms are family farms? There's a look at some of your potential answers. Plasma would love to put together a nice long meat
drive.
Grinding drive here.
Add to the, 217 rushing yards so far today.
Cole Davis remains in at quarterback, and he will hand it off to Dunn. Two Sycamores right there in the backfield to take him down after no gain. Thurman finishes him off.
Well, we talked about it, and you mentioned it too when NDSU got over the 200-yard mark, how many times they've done that this year, still coming in averaging 225 on the ground. Excellent production today, and the Bison defense holding Indiana State from getting 100 yet.
Warlock hits the hole hard. He gets three. 84 up to the 19. Before he stopped and driven back. North Dakota State, 225 rush yards a game on average, is 15th in the FCS. And it's not like they've gone up against defenses that give up a lot of yards. We look at Youngstown, Northern Iowa, Western Illinois, among others. They're really good against the run.
I mean, their biggest ground was the game against Eastern, the overtime one. That was 280.
There's a look at your Bobcat game recap. 5 plays, 50 yards, and 217 there for Indiana State. Nunez with the field goal.
Again, the Bison have been stingy with points today, only giving up the 10, but that defense has been out on the field quite a bit today.
60 plays, yeah, for the defense. Play action this time from Davis. Rolling, firing, caught. Well executed on both ends.
Boy, his window to squeeze that that pass into Jensen was really, really small because Thurman was right there defensively. So you had your linebacker on your tight end, Davis on the move. Needed to kind of hit that low outside corner, and he did.
Yeah, Nate Jensen making his first catch of the afternoon. And Jensen was targeted quite a bit early in the conference season as James Hendricks comes into the game. Hendricks, a redshirt freshman, played at Bemidji High School, was a coach's kid there. Hendricks is going to run it. Although I don't think he's going to get away.
No, he's going down.
From Devin Brockington, who caught him from the backside, and he lost 5-6 yards.
Yeah, corner blitz on the backside against the run. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay coming off the top of your screen. There you see the corner, Brockington. Of course, you don't account for anyone on a corner blitz. Nothing much Hendricks could do on that. Have to eat it, take the loss.
Let's look at our trivia answer to our question brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean and North Dakota Corn Councils. What percent of U.S. farms are family farms? The answer is 97%. Back to the ground game. Not much room to run that time for Damaris Purifoy, another redshirt freshman out of Wauwatosa, Wisconsin. He's been dinged up throughout the season, getting an opportunity here.
Now on third down, you're going to see Erzendowski and Shepard and Williams and Morlock are back in now.
Along with Cole Davis, who comes back in on third and 13. Four receivers in the formation for NDSU. Davis, time, fires across the middle, tips, and incomplete. Getting his hands up nicely that time to make the play was Cottrell Moss.
Yeah, it looked like Davis was in a pretty decent comfort zone on his drop, and he had a deep kind of a post coming that was open over the middle, but he couldn't squeeze it over the linebacker to give his receiver a chance.
So that will bring on Jackson Koontz. Rondell Green once again back deep for Indiana State. Oops. Green's going to have an opportunity to return this one. That's not very common. It's the second return punt of the season as the flag comes in for Rondell Green. He's in NDSU territory of the 46, but we'll see what's going on with the flag.
One of the Bison players had a helmet pop off his head, and that was MJ Stump. I don't know if that was where the mix-up was between those two players. I think it was, though.
Personal foul. 46 on the receiving team. 15-yard penalty. First down, Indiana State.
We'll take a timeout.
Media
Indiana State
timeout.
Backed up. 41-10, your score. 9:02 to go from here in Fargo.
Get your horns out.
41-10, your score, 9:02 to go. Indiana State will take over in their own territory at the 39-yard line after the personal foul.
Number of new faces in there defensively now for the Bison.
Inside handoff, Genesee picks his way, gain 6. And Beth Houle on the sidelines with a special guest. Yep, the former offensive lineman that now plays with the Indianapolis Colts. Beth.
That's right, Joe Haig joining me here on his bye week from the NFL. Joe, first question off the top, how has the NFL been?
It's been crazy. It's definitely a step up in the game, and everyone's faster, stronger. But it's a challenge. But you kind of just gotta approach it as a challenge and try to just go out there and do what you can. But it's been fun overall. I've met a lot of great people, and I'm excited for the rest of the season.
You stepped in your rookie season and you're making an impact with the Colts. So is this what you were expecting, and how has that transition been for you?
Yeah, I mean, my main goal when I first got to the team was I need to be as flexible as possible, especially being a young offensive lineman. Just being able to step up wherever you can, that's a big deal. And I think that's just something that I worked on, and I was able to show my versatility, and that's something that has allowed me to get all these game reps, and something that just makes me better.
Who's helped you with that transition, maybe the best, since you've joined the Colts?
Honestly, probably just the vets in our O-line room. We have a lot of great guys in there. They're all, everyone wants everyone to be successful. I mean, even if you're competing with that person for a spot, we're all helping each other out. And we just have a great group of guys in that room that have helped all the rookies.
What's been the biggest surprise for you since joining the NFL?
Gosh, I don't know. it's just honestly, I don't know. I mean, it's kind of what I expected in some ways. And a lot of some ways, it's like, okay, it's kind of like college. You know, there's a lot as far as, you know, like the whole locker room atmosphere. But it's just been an awesome experience. I'm just excited about it.
Do you still feel that Bison pride, that Bison connection when you're out there?
Oh, yeah. I talk a lot of smack to the guys. If we there was a couple of Iowa guys in our team, so I was, you know, making sure they heard enough about it. But then, I love, you know, I love being part of the Bison, you know, nation, and it's awesome.
And how about to see your Bison brothers out there across the NFL? I mean, the most there's ever been active right now in the NFL.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. I mean, this program does a great job of developing players. We're all coachable, and everyone just kind of buys into what we have here, and that's something that you've seen, you know, show up in the NFL now.
Well, thanks for joining us back here on the sideline. Appreciate you stopping by. Guys?
All right, thanks so much. Great to see Joe again. We really enjoyed our conversation with Joe in the spring game.
Yeah, that was
and,
fun.
Amazing what he's been able to do in his rookie season as a fifth-round draft choice. He's come in and played a very important role for the Colts.
I mean, obviously with, you know, Wentz and what he's done.
Uh-oh. Genesee has a head of steam and pushed out of bounds by Quinton McCoy inside the 10-yard line.
My point is, though, is you can't do this, but if you took Carson out of the equation, how much praise and talk do you think would be going on right now about what Joe Haig has accomplished in the NFL as a rookie, starting, getting drafted, all of that type of stuff? I mean, he's the Sportscasters and Sportswriters College Male Athlete of the Year last year because of what he, you know, accomplished as an offensive lineman for the Bison.
And really a great story. We've talked about it a bunch, but the fact that this guy was a walk-on, you know, was only 220 pounds when he got to campus. I mean, there's a lot of things you can look back as a success story. Almost a guy you could write a movie or a book about, really.
My favorite thing is when Joe joined us during the spring game last year. And
please put 6 minutes, 12 seconds on the game clock.
And we asked
play it, clock 25 seconds.
We asked Joe in the national championship game against Jacksonville State and all the hype that their defensive line had, and there were all D1 transfers. When did you know you had them? After the first drive. He's right then. Joe and the offensive line knew that they'd be more physical than Jacksonville State and that they would win.
Trying to step out of a tackle. Boy, bouncing off a couple of guys and gets down to the 5-yard line. Marquise Bridges, he's talked about all the new faces. Hard to keep everybody, track of everybody that's come in and out.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Levi, you're the same.
Brinkman.
Brinkman right there, who loses his hat, has to come off a play. But you mentioned Marquise Bridges, number 9, who's coming in there late. I mean, he's playing a position right now that he wasn't at when the season started.
He was a wide receiver, and there's a need at corner, and Marquise did that in high school at De La Salle in Minneapolis.
Now he's guarding one-on-one on the high side with veteran receiver Thompson.
Genesee head to the 2-yard line before he's taken down. 19th carry already for Genesee. He's getting close to 100 yards on the day.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, trying to follow his tight end up, gets through the first guy, right over, I think that was Jordheim, and now third down and what, 2.
Genesee, did he get in?
Yes.
Yes, he did. Touchdown. On the 20th carry of the afternoon, Roland Genesee is in for the touchdown. And he's about 97 yards rushing now on the day. Take another look at it here on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
So as we look at it, the booth will look at it as well. Was that leg and knee and hip down before he crossed?
Sanford hoping that there is no visual evidence to dispute that.
Looking at it from the back corner of the end zone here. Knee,
ooh,
shoulder.
I don't think so.
Might be short. If it is, it's certainly not by much.
Again, it's got to be foolproof evidence, and I don't know if that's it or not. We'll see. Mike Sanford's squad will head on the bus, get on the plane, get back to Terre Haute, get to work on recruiting.
They'll finish with a 4-7 record. Kind of hard to tell where you think the ball is. If the point of the ball or any part of that ball is over that line before you rule that the knee and the hip were there,
they're done looking at it.
Ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Seems like the right call, LT, based on the angles
so.
We saw. Yeah.
Sure.
It's tough to tell one way or the other. It might have been short, but boy, just don't know.
Again, not enough to say definitively that it was not in.
Crowd is definitely filing out here at the Fargo Dome as we're under 5 minutes to go, and this one clearly in hand for North Dakota State.
Tremendous first half played by the Bison.
And we will take a timeout, 41-17.
Get your horns.
We'll be back with our final 4:52. Your score, Indiana State. Just punching one in on a Roland Gennessy two-yard run. 18,276 here to see it at the Fargo Dome today. Ty Brooks giving chase back to the zone two. Brooks finding a seam, hitting it hard, and then pushing ahead to about the 22.
Trey Fort trying to kind of get a hold of him and grab on and get a couple extra yards.
We'll take another timeout, 41-17. Cole Davis taking the Bison offense back out to their own 23-yard line, and pretty much backups across the board in this time for NDSU, especially on the offensive line. Purifoy getting his second carry, getting a yard up to the 24.
Trying to sneak in there and run a little power, kind of a different look. Triplett pulls around, and where he pulled from is where they tried to run it.
Ty Brooks will check in a tailback for Purifoy, and some pretty high hopes, I think, for Damaris. He's, again, been injured, has not taken as many reps as I think they would have liked him to take, but his potential is certainly there.
And it's only his second year in the program, too, so.
Back to power from Ty Brooks, following his blocks, gets what he can. Up to the 27-yard line.
Late flag.
So this is all about.
Well, the pile was unraveling when the flag came out. I don't know if that's because someone was jawing or if someone was doing some extra twisting.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Offense, number 28. Half the distance to the goal. Third down.
Well, Chris Kleiman doesn't like it. It goes on Ty Brooks, the redshirt freshman running back. This copyrighted broadcast is property of North Dakota State University. Any rebroadcast, reproduction, or distribution without the consent of NDSU is strictly prohibited.
Coach Kleiman still trying to understand. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Here's they're unpiling. And there's a little bit of a shove there after trying to get his head cleared from underneath the arm.
Dimitri Williams on the fly sweep. Gained some yardage back up to the 27. Bison will still have to punt well short of a first down, and Mike Sanford's going to call for a timeout. Oh, Chris Kleiman is in the ear of Ty Brooks. Saying, Lance Dunn, go talk to him.
Could be the last play that he plays today, too. Well, what do you do if you're Coach Sanford? Last year, injuries. You could look at injuries and say that was one of the major reasons why Indiana State struggled as it did. This year, they meaning the Sycamores, have not had those big injuries and have not had a very good last half of the year.
Yeah, things just started to unravel. Again, they had the lead against Youngstown State until a punt return beat them. Was taken by Green. Fisher, look at him give chase.
Got him.
Fisher got him. How about the hustle by the long snapper?
James Fisher with the tackle.
The Bloomington Kennedy Eagle making a play.
Way to slide that in with enthusiasm.
I love those Bloomington Kennedy Eagles. You got one on the women's basketball team playing tonight too.
Fisher's not going to let him get around the corner. Grab the jersey and makes the solo tackle.
Rondell Green, you got to go back on the plane. Some guy goes, he just got tackled by the long snapper. Hand off inside. Boy, pretty good footwork
moves
there from Genesee. He was over 100 yards rushing on the day. Gets 11 there, up to the 32.
Yeah, he had to make a move with, I think, each hip on that particular play. Around one, around the other, and he picks up the first down.
Well, the final game for Roland Genesee will be a memorable one for him. Certainly not in the scoreboard, but one of his best performances by far of his career. Young will throw in the slot. Boy, Dom Davis had that thing read as Levingston was the intended target.
Yeah, the Bison have the nickel, which means that Davis is already out there, and his job is to play that slot receiver. Just a little bit, just a, you know, not, almost a slant. Davis didn't have to go very far to get in and knock that one away. Good read.
Darren Kelly, Jackson Brown, the two new safeties in there for NDSU. Tuska giving chase. Young gets away, and now Young throws, and it's complete. Pretty good adjustment there to come back to the football by Clayton Smith.
Tell you, Young has probably, when he's going to his left, has been his most effective today.
13 of 26 now for Young on the day. 86 yards passing. Young across the middle. Boy, good coverage again. That's time by Marlette.
Still a catch, though.
Yep.
Hey, the middle linebacker draped all over him. Marlette tried to swing that, his free arm, his front arm, right arm around, and knocked that ball away. Couldn't quite do it.
Tanyan makes the catch. That's just his third catch of the day with only 19 yards receiving for Robert Tanyan. So he's certainly not had the impact that we've seen him have in other games in the Missouri Valley.
Especially when Indiana State was playing well at the beginning of the year. Tiny was getting a lot of catches.
Oh boy. There's no way he got there yet as Keys is dropped for a loss of three.
Another fourth down stop for the Bison. Boy, NDSU has been so good in fourth down this year. And now the second unit with a stop on fourth down. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Real good penetration up the middle.
Cold
bounces
cars
off of Cars. Marlette hit him a little bit.
Darren Kelly got in there too from a safety spot. Transfer from North Dakota State College of Science. So Brock Robbins, you see number 34.
Oh, Tim Polasek to
told us he would like to play him at least a few reps today, and they're hopeful by next week he'll be able to play a larger role at fullback. Again, had a broken foot the last 6-7 weeks. He has not played.
Well, you just keep hearing, you know, and especially when he's healthy before the broken foot in practice, and especially last spring, how physical and how well Robbins has been playing from that fullback position. And of course, if you've watched any Bison football, you know, over the course of this championship run especially, you know how important the fullback is.
Grant Malmstrom has done a nice job coming on and filling in, but again, he missed some time because of injury, so Chase Morlock's had to play there. They've used Jeff Ilias, some others in that position. Purifoy again, not much that time. Some more extracurriculars.
Still trying to make the block about 7 yards after he lost his helmet.
And Oki Moala coming in to make that tackle on Purifoy.
One play.
Now, Mesner switched jerseys, did he not, to go to 62?
He must have, because he had 98 on earlier, and yeah, that had to be. That was him, wasn't it?
I think so.
Yep, that was Bryce. Because you can't have that 90s number and play the interior
right
on the offensive line.
Please place 38 seconds on the game clock.
Well, the crowd that's left here doesn't like it.
No, but you know what? The rules are the rules, and if you're the official, it's your job to officiate the game correctly, whether it's in the last minute or the first minute.
They still haven't put 38 on the clock yet.
So now you have to have the runoff.
So we have 31 to 38 back to 28. And there's probably about 2,000 people, if that, left in the building.
Sounds like a combination to a school locker or something.
Well, barring anything crazy, this should be the final play of the game. Purifoy was smacked pretty good that time.
Thurman
got one more good shot in to end his career.
Probably fitting for as many tackles as he's had on his career for the Sycamores that he gets the last one today. But the Bison rack up another win
and move to 9-1 on the season. And they will finish the season at South Dakota next week. Indiana State, their season concludes, and they finish 4-7 on the season. And they'll head back to Terre Haute and get to work on recruiting and getting ready for the offseason.
Boy, the big punt return right off the bat. You have DRG Tucker with the big hit right off the bat. So you have, you know, a couple of nice plays to get everyone excited. And then the Bison, you know, pounded really well in the first half and took the game away in the first half.
243 yards on the ground, 316 total. But again, North Dakota State really had a majority of those yards in the first half and then really took their foot off the gas, so to speak. Chris Kleiman standing by with Beth Houle.
All right, Coach Kleiman, able to get some of your other guys in that game. How important is that for you guys?
Well, it's good to get some of our starters a rest because next week's going to be a big game playing for another Missouri Valley Conference championship.
You guys are able to get the win here for your seniors. How much does this help in the celebration to come, and how fitting is this for this group of young men?
Well, they've been everything. You know, they've been a phenomenal group for 5, 4, 3, 2 years, and I wouldn't be in the position I am without those guys.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations on the win.
All right, thanks so much, Beth. And North Dakota State, we'll head to Vermilion next weekend, but we'll celebrate this one for a few short hours before getting ready for the Coyotes. And we will be back to wrap things up here on the KDLY KFYR Bison Network. 41-17 your final. NDSU finishes off their final regular season home game in fitting fashion. North Dakota State victorious again. and back to 9 wins with a chance to get to 10 next week against the University of South Dakota, who dropped a tough matchup in Brookings today, 28-21, to SDSU. Take a look at our NODAC Mutual Insurance Player of the Game, and fitting it goes to Pierre G. Tucker, one of the seniors, had a nice game today.
He did. Here he's coming in and getting a sack on the quarterback, Young. He also had that big hit early in the game, and I think here we're going to see it. Little pass. Anytime you can de-cleat someone, it really makes you happy. He had that big hit against Youngstown last week, 12 total tackles for Tucker. The old reverse the field is not going to work, and Pierre G with his 12 tackles, 8 solos, and that one sack we showed you, the player of the game.
NODAC Mutual Insurance, player of the game. LT and I will be back with your final stats after this from the Dome. ...41-17 your final. LT and Bichon back to wrap things up here at the Fargo Dome as we take a look at your final stats brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers.
A couple of things on this that stand out to me. I think the obvious one there is the rushing yards. For NDSU getting 243 rushing yards. The other one, I think, is Indiana State's passing yards. They did not get to 100. In college football, it's pretty tough to hold a team under 100 yards passing when Young attempted 27 passes and you gave up only 90 yards. That's pretty good stuff by the Bison. Of course, Indiana State in the time of possession, they're going to win that thing. But the Bison in that first half rolled up the score. The nice punt return got things started. You have a 7-point edge before your offense even comes out. And did the Bison passing game go today how they wanted it to? No. Did the rushing game go as you expected it? Yes.
That's the most important thing, I think, for NDSU is continuing to control the line of scrimmage, and that's what they'll have to do next week against South Dakota. What other thoughts do you have as they go on to take a USD team that has a running quarterback? They've been dangerous at times, but one of those teams that's coming off a pretty tough loss today in Brookings.
Yeah, the Coyotes coming off the loss, but they still have their one game. But you go, okay, who's playing for what in the last game of the year? Well, the Bison are playing for a lot. They're playing for a bye, a potential, the top four, maybe even higher, playoff seed. So there's a lot on the line in that game next week for Vermilion. And usually when there's the team with the most on the line usually has the most production in that particular game. And next week we know that'll be the Bison.
And Illinois State won again today over Missouri State, 37-0. And Northern Iowa won on the road at Western Illinois. So South Dakota State goes to UNI. That's not a gimme for the Jacks next week. So that'll be an interesting final week setting up here in the Valley.
Yeah, right now SDSU and NDSU tied for the top. There could be a sole possession for the champion, of course. Bison will need some help on that game. But, yeah, I would not want to play the Panthers right now. They're playing pretty well.
Yeah, they're going to be an interesting matchup. Always an interesting final week in the Valley and playoff season, everything on the line as well. Thanks so much for tuning in all across the statewide network on the KVLY, KFYR Bison Network. For Beth Houle, Lee Timmerman, our entire crew, I'm Brian Shaw saying so long from the Fargo Dome. The Bison win on Senior Day, 41-17. We'll see you next Saturday from Vermilion, South Dakota, as NDSU looks to finish off the regular season with their 10th victory and win another Missouri Valley Conference title. We'll see you then next Saturday in Vermilion. Have a great Saturday afternoon, everyone.